Both teams tested in close games, and the Irish, their last three, all decided in the final seconds. Notre Dame at 3-1, and Washington at 2-2. Charlie Weiss has elected to defer to the second half after Notre Dame won the toss. So the Irish will play defense to open the game, and it'll be Washington with the ball first. The freshman kicker, Nick Tausch, ready to tee it up. And there's a look at the return men, with Justin Glenn and Richardson.
Tony Weiss mentioned to us, really happy with Nick Tausch's kickoffs last week.
They've been a little short early in the season. But
the last kick last week, he said, was critical for the come-behind win.
So, Notre Dame and Washington from sold-out Notre Dame Stadium. Has the okay, and here we go. It is Richardson. Quentin Richardson with a lane. And all the way out close to the 40-yard line. Good field position for the Huskies after a 35-yard return. Special teams tackle with David Pozlewski making it for the Irish, but not until that good return put the Huskies in great shape.
By the kicking team, 5-yard penalty from the end of the run, first down.
And it was an offside penalty as well, which tacks on 5 yards to the end of the run. It's a Pac-10 crew here today with Brian O'Kane, the referee. There's Jake Locker, the Pac-10 freshman of the year a couple seasons ago, who leads the conference in total offense this season. From the 39-yard line, Locker's in the shotgun. First down handoff is to Chris Polk. And Polk grinds out a few yards up the middle. Gave him about 5 yards on that first down carry. Makes it 2nd and 5 for the Huskies. Second down, Locker again from the shotgun. Play action, fake, completes the pass to Polk out of the backfield. Polk unable to get away and fumbles the football, and Notre Dame recovers.
Yeah, Polk was just trying to scramble, you know, bust through for a couple extra yards, Tom, and in the churning and churning and trying to gain those extra 2 or 3 yards.
And Robert Blant recovers it back.
Yeah, and Kyle McCarthy, you called him Mr. Dependable at the open, just kind of hangs on to get some help from Manti Te'o, the freshman who gets a start, and then Darren Wallace makes the recovery.
And they're going to review it, as was the case the last time we were here. The replay officials are Big East officials.
Remember, Steve Sarkisian just told Alex Flanagan, protect the football was the key to our offensive game. And
they had good field position and were moving, too.
Opening drive. No, his knee down. Yeah, his knee was down.
Looked like it from that angle, his knee was down before the fumble.
I think that will be overturned.
Robert Welsh and Ed Ferrante are the replay officials.
Left knee down, ball in possession. Shouldn't be a fumble. Should be right down right there.
We just saw it better from the other angle, didn't we? We could clearly see his knee down here. Knee down right there.
In possession. That should not be a fumble.
So it should remain Washington's ball if they overturn the ruling on the field.
For Washington, protect the football on offense. 3 turnovers last week against Stanford. And then when they get on defense, they have to tackle a lot better than they did against the Cardinal last week.
They were just shredded by the running game last week.
You know, Stanford's pretty good at running the ball.
They are. Think of Stanford being a physical team, but they really are.
Maybe the most physical in the Pac-10. And Steve Sarkisian, his first coach, really added a new energy up in Washington. Only 35 years old, really kind of changed the whole face of the program and the way they practice. The practices are open, lots of people come in. It's just an entirely different feel around the Husky program.
Of course, he comes from USC as their offensive coordinator, was a pretty good quarterback himself at BYU in his playing days. Discussing things with his quarterback locker.
Yeah, he's also, just like Charlie Weiss says, he calls plays for the Huskies. You see him, that big colorful sheet in front of him.
So Utah State and Washington electing to clear out their entire staffs in the offseason.
After review, the ruling is that the runner's knee was down prior to loss of possession. It does make the line of gain. First down.
So we agree with the call. First down, Washington. As a result of the play, replay overturns the fumble ruling on the field.
And that's from an official named Brian O'Kane.
So Locker checking his armband with the play call.
120 plays on that armband, Tom.
Well, they announced a first down here, but it's not actually a first down. It's third down and about a yard.
Years past, Jake Locker, this was his kind of down where he just basically took over and ran for it. A little different offensive system for the Huskies this year. Is this a slow start?
The chains had already moved with the change of possession, and so the officials are trying to sort out the placement of the football. Again, it's a Pac-10 officiating crew, Big East replay officials. And it looks like the referee, Brian O'Kane, is going to return to the headset and get some help from the replay officials as to the spotting of the football.
Here they have it running a 42 right now. And
these lines, of course, are not official.
Whoever's left knee, whoever the ball is when his left knee goes down.
Correction on the play. They did not make the line to gain. It will be third down and one.
So he's making the correction now. It would not be a first down. It will be third down and one. I think we got everything sorted out correctly.
That's a slow start, wouldn't you say? Just uneven.
For us or for them?
It's always for us, Tom.
So third and one. Already in Irish territory. Power formation. And looks like a false start. A lot of finger pointing on both sides, but I think the flag will go against the Huskies. Now the Huskies linemen are pointing toward Notre Dame, but they have retreated. Five-yard penalty against Chris Isbicki, one of the tight ends.
Well, beginning to look a little bit like an NFL preseason game. Left tight end at the top, number four, just gets a little move. And John Ryan's the first one to a point.
So now it's third down and six, and no more power formation. They go with three wides. Send Goodwin in motion as Locker retreats, scrambles away. Remember, he's a good runner. And he has the first down as he scrambles into the grasp of Scott Smith, but not until he picked up the first on a gain of eight.
Well, you said at the very top, he can beat you throwing or running. He's become a much better passer this year, but do not forget he almost ran for 1,000 yards 2 years ago as the Pac-10 Freshman of the Year. The pocket was really squeezed. They had him guided, breaks the tackle of Manti Te'o, and enough oomph and strength to get the first down by Locker.
Locker missed the last eight games of last season with a broken thumb. And the toss to Polk. Chris Polk with a couple of blockers, but the blockers didn't get anybody out of the way, and he's tackled after a short game. And let's take a look at our starting lineups, brought to you by Adidas. Offensive line for the Huskies, and center Ryan Toler, his third year as a starter, anchors that offensive line. In the backfield, Polk averages nearly 4 yards a carry, and freshman Johnson is the top receiver. Second down and seven. Locker, good protection. Goes underneath. And to Goodwin, who is knocked out of bounds, just short of the first down, it appears.
Well, you know, Steve Sarkisian's coached a lot of good quarterbacks over the years, and Alex Flanagan talked to him about that. But, you know, in this guy, Jake Locker, he was a kind of a run-first quarterback, Tom, you know, his first couple of years. What they're trying to do is coach him to do just what he did there, hang in the pocket, wait for that receiver to break open, and then deliver the ball, which he just did.
As you saw, good at converting third downs. This is third down and a yard. Toss to Polk. And Chris Polk is still going all the way down to the 25-yard line for a Washington first down. A gain on the play of 10 yards.
Good lead block by Paul Homer, the fullback, who just really cleared the hole for him. He's right up in here, and watch what he does leading the way for Chris Polk. The fullbacks don't get, you know, and he blocked, was it Kyle McCarthy when they
Mr.
Defendable
out of the
back
way.
About five yards. So the lead block by Homer allows Polk to pick up the first.
From the Irish 25, from the shotgun, Locker on first down. Looks one way, goes the other, sets up a little screen to Curse. Jermaine Curse is down to the 11-yard line. Another Washington first down. That one gained 14. And here.
Curse is the guy that Steve Sarkisian was saying to us this week, hey, we've got to get him more involved. He was spent too much time on the bench last week against Stanford. Got his start last year as a freshman against the Irish. And a guy that they feel is very, very dependable. Picked up the first down there.
First down, Washington at the Notre Dame 11-yard line. They empty the backfield as Polk goes in motion, sets to the right. Locker looks, finds a man wide open. It's Middleton, one of his tight ends, to the 5-yard line. Kyle McCarthy finally got him down after Middleton sort of lost his footing.
You know, they don't play on regular grass up in Seattle. AstroTurf up there. Tavario Middleton, number 80, a guy who's just caught his 11th pass on the year. If that ball's thrown out in front of him, maybe he breaks a tackle and gets in.
Second down and 4 from the Notre Dame 5. They can't make a first down without scoring.
And you always have to account for Locker here.
Here he is. Quarterback draw, Jake Locker. For the touchdown.
Same play they ran against USC for a touchdown. Quarterback draw, and that's what makes a running, powerful quarterback so difficult to defend, a defensive coordinator's nightmare.
6'3", 226, Jake Locker powers into the end zone.
Good block by the center, Tolar, too, kind of cleared the way for him. And Kristen as well.
And Eric Folk lines up for the point after. He's hit 11 for 11. And that one is good. So helped out by replay's reversal of a fumble. Washington on their first possession marches down the field. 9 plays, 56 yards, up 7-0. Campus of the University of Notre Dame, Jake Locker hit all 4 of his passes to 4 different receivers on that 9 play, 56-yard touchdown drive. And so Folk is ready to kick it to that man, Theo Riddick. Riddick at the 10. A little room up the middle. And then the hole closes down at the 35-yard line, and the kicker, Folk, makes the special teams tackle. So now Jimmy Clausen, who has been so impressive this season with the 4th best quarterback rating in the country, 10 touchdowns, 1 interception, 65% completions.
He really has played beautifully. I mean, particularly throwing the deep ball, Tom. He has been so on with the long ball.
Two tight ends to begin for the Irish, Rudolph and Ragone. And Armando Allen gets the pitch and hands off on the reverse. Here's Golden Tate. He's got a blocker in front. He is down the sideline and just tripped up at the 35-yard line of Washington by the freshman Desmond Trufant. 31-yard gain on the reverse.
That's because he's going motion here. He'll play X, he'll play halfback, and boy, that was beautifully designed. I tell you, Trufant did a pretty good job of saving a touchdown.
Open field tackle.
Yeah. One of the things they didn't do well last week against Stanford, but Trufant brings a very difficult guy down in Golden Tate.
So from the 34-yard line of Washington.
Now Tate is in his second position down here as an X. His Z, now he's an X. It's two different ones.
Armando Allen has blockers. And it's inside the 30-yard line on a first down run. Tackled by Mason Foster. As we take a look at our Adidas starting lineups for the Notre Dame offense. Here's the offensive line. Watch Olsen, the center, as he aggressively gestures sometimes to adjust the line coverage. And in the backfield, we saw Allen carrying. He's back after that injury. And of course, look for Tate in a variety of ways today.
Olsen does gesticulate, doesn't he?
This time it's a Clausen's turn. Handing to Allen. Armando breaks free. Armando Allen caught by the shoe top just inside the 10 by Justin Glenn. A gain of 21 yards.
Two big runs by the Irish. Now, again, the Huskies really have played poorly against the run, giving up 5.8 yards. Good blocks on the right side. Sam Young did his thing, the lead block by Bobby Berger. And then a good open field tackle by Justin Glenn. But the Huskies giving up 5.8 yards of rush and gave up 321 yards last week, Tom, to Stanford. Charlie absolutely took note of that. In the Wildcat formation.
Armando Allen ready to see receive the direct snap. Fakes it. Allen keeps. Flags are down, and Allen is down for a loss on the play. Josh Gage, the linebacker, was all over him from the outset.
Holding, number 83 on the offense, 10-yard penalty, replay first down.
And Mike Ragone is guilty of the hold. And they declined the penalty.
Well, you know, without Michael Floyd, the Irish trot in Shaquille Evans and Deion Walker. Again, Charlie looking for ways to replace Michael Floyd, so you can see a lot more of Shaquille Evans, number 11, and Deion Walker, number 1.
So decline the penalty after a loss of 6. It's second down and 14. Golden Tate in the backfield at running back as Clausen completes it to Evans, and Shaq Evans fumbled the ball for a moment.
And he said it was
that is down.
Now you mentioned Tate being in the backfield, Tom. That's now three different positions. He played split end, flanker, and now running back. Just trying to find ways to get him single coverage. That guy, he's a big-time receiver. It was so much easier when he had Michael Floyd on the other side. Took a lot of pressure off him. So Charlie Weiss moving him around.
Tate, the running back in high school, familiar with that position. And now it's third down, third and goal from the 15-yard line.
Here's Kyle Rudolph now kind of lined up as a wide receiver. You know, that's a matchup they like. Maybe a jump ball to him.
So here in the red zone, they've got Rudolph at wide receiver. Clausen goes that way. And they got their feet tangled up. And the ball was caught, but I think but out of bounds. So no interception on the play by Quentin Richardson. But he and Rudolph, as they threw it up, Rudolph got their feet entangled.
Yeah, absolutely. But again, you like the play call, right? You got a 6'6 rebounder there. There's how they get tied up. But good play by Quentin Richardson. Actually, really should have intercepted had he not bobbled it.
So a 34-yard field goal attempt by the freshman Nick Towers. He's hit 5 of 6. On its way, and it is good. So Notre Dame stalls a bit after they look good early, and they settle for the field goal. It's 7-3, UW. Welcome back to Notre Dame Stadium, where Washington leads the Irish 7-3 with 7:11 to go in the opening quarter. Washington scored on his first possession a touchdown. Notre Dame responds with a field goal. And so Tausch has it teed up ready to kick off to Glenn and Richardson. shorter kick this time, taken by Richardson. And a good return to open the game. This one not quite as good, although it comes across the 25-yard line. For Steve Sarkisian, the new coach of the Huskies. And as we said, he was a pretty good quarterback in his days at BYU. Then he played in the CFL for a couple of years. Joined the staff at USC. Spent a year in the NFL with the Raiders before returning to USC as their offensive coordinator. And now 35 years old, taking over as the Washington head coach.
Well, he's developed two Heisman Trophy quarterbacks at USC. And you talk to any of those guys, and they say this guy can really coach the position. And I think it helps play.
Of course, as a Trojan assistant, at Notre Dame's number that came in to
block in the
play.
Back on the kickoff, Tom.
Penalty for blocking in the back on the kickoff puts it back at the 17-yard line. Locker's pass. Incomplete diving attempt made by Jermaine Kearse.
It was funny when Steve Sarkisian was talking to us yesterday. He said, you know, he'd be coming into the locker room here, the visiting locker room, since 2001. He said, some coach put up a play on the wall, and it's still there after all those years. There it is. And then this is the locker room. He said, you know, I was in there today. This is yesterday. He said, this is, you know, a play that some coach drew up. You know, it had to be 10 years ago.
And some other coach in blue wrote there 11 as one. Second down. Polk. Chris Polk got a couple of tough yards.
I tell you, the Irish have played much better run defense the past 2 weeks. One of the reasons is John Tenuta does not bring as much pressure, not bringing as many blitzers. And those down linemen, Ethan Johnson and Capron Lewis-Moore, Ian Williams, they've done a nice job. And now, today, they've moved Brian Smith to middle linebacker. Manti Te'o, the outstanding, highly recruited freshman, starting at their will outside linebacker.
Today's first down line brought to you by Xerox. Te'o, in fact, made that last tackle, setting up a third down and 9. Screen pass complete to Kearse. Diving ahead for the first down. There's a penalty marker back in the Washington backfield.
Kearse has run that twice, that little screen twice, quite well.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Number 9 on the defense. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
Ethan Johnson called for roughing the passer.
Ethan Johnson, number 9. I don't know about that one, Tom.
That's pretty picky.
Nonetheless, 15 more would have had a first down regardless.
So now from the 44-yard line, first down for the Huskies. Play action fake, Locker. Rushed and hit as he delivered incomplete.
Ethan Johnson right there.
And here's a look at our Adidas starting lineups for the Notre Dame defense. As you said, that defensive line better against the run against Purdue. It put some pressure on Locker that time. Among the linebackers, Smith moves to the middle, and the heralded freshman Te'o getting the start today. And in the secondary, McCarthy leads the team with 37 tackles and 3 interceptions. Second and 10. Chris Polk.
Good tackle inside. It looked like Polk was going to gain some. Capron Lewis-Moore, you were just talking about those guys, Tom. Number 89 for the Irish. And we were talking to Randy Hart, his coach this week, said had his best game last week against Purdue. Good inside tackle that time by Lewis-Moore.
Washington, 3 for 3 on third down so far today. This is 3rd and 5. Locker standing in, now has to scramble away, crosses midfield short of the first down.
Good coverage that time by the Irish, because he had plenty of time to find somebody, but boy, there just wasn't much down here. Good absolutely good protection, but coverage on the double coverage top and bottom, nowhere to go.
Gary Neal finally made the stop. So on fourth down, Will Mahan is on to punt, averaging 42.7 a punt. Low snap, got it away toward Golden Tate, who calls for a fair catch and makes it at the 20-yard line. 30-yard punt with no return, and the Irish will take over at their own 20-yard line. Boston ready to return, trailing 7-3. Go to irish.nbcsports.com now and blog live about the Irish while watching today's game. You can also get analysis, live commentary, and more exclusively on nbcsports.com. On first down, Wildcat formation with Armando Allen ready to take the snap. There it is, and a handoff is to Golden Tate. And then back to Clawson. Flag is down. And so is Clawson at the 10-yard line. They weren't fooled by that little bit of razzle-dazzle. And Clawson a little gimpy as he gets up. Remember, he's playing with the turf toe, which is not going to be a 100% heal probably until the season is over.
I was upset about hurting his toe again, or that Robbie Parris was wide open.
Second down.
Illegal block in the back by Eric Olson. And Clawson still limping a little bit. Has a shield in that
metal
shoe to a metal plate to protect that toe. They said it was much better this week. It was no longer purple and swollen as it was last week, but still not 100%. Second down and 20. The action fake, and Clawson chased from the pocket. Throws on the run, wide open to Parris. And Robbie Parris breaks a tackle and gets a first down.
Really, he's persistent, Robbie Parris. He was wide open on the last play, and Jimmy Clawson with the bad toe and all, just in all, moving kind of around in the pocket, allows Robbie Parris kind of filling in for Michael Floyd. Good route run. He wants the ball. Get it to me, he's saying. And then pretty good after the catch. The guy that, as this season wears on for the Irish, is really going to have to be an important guy. I had a member that had that long catch or important catch last week.
Yeah, key catch in the winning touchdown drive. That one went for 26 yards. Here's Tate in the backfield.
He's a fullback.
And now in motion. Clawson to Tate. Gets it at the 40-yard line. And then surrounded by Huskies who get the late hit call as they ride him out of bounds and right in front of defensive coordinator Nick Holt.
After the play, personal foul, number 66 on the defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Well, we've seen when Golden Tate is, fifth, different position, Tom, including returning punts. Again, he's a hard guy, a really hard guy to bring down. Get out of bounds and easy call for the officials. He's just one hard guy to tackle.
Four and a 15-yard penalty, so 19 yards total on that play for the Irish. They're at the 45 of the Huskies. Allen, hit and dropped in the backfield. Great penetration by Donald Butler. As we look at the Adidas starting lineups for that Huskies defense. Defensive line, Teo Nessem has 19 and a half career sacks. He's been praised by coaches from both of these teams. Just saw Butler make the big hit on that play. He's the top tackler and the key to the defense for the Huskies. And in the secondary, true freshman Trufant getting the start at a quarterback. Made a touchdown saving tackle on the first series by the Irish. Play action. Clawson ducks under the rush. Scrambles free and dives. Armando Allen gave him a little block, enabling him to get away from what would have been a sack.
Yeah, remember he was sacked, what, it was a 57 times 3 years ago, his freshman year, and he has just done a great job of knowing where to throw the ball, throwing it away, and sometimes dancing around the pocket. They had a clean shot at him. Quentin Richardson just missed him. No hitter there by Quentin Richardson. That should have been a sack, but a good play by Clawson to avoid it.
Third down for the Irish, third and eight. Allen in motion. Empty backfield now with five wide. Fawcett, no rush. And he finds Allen for the first down. Armando Allen with his eighth reception of the season. Gain of 13 yards and the protection of the offensive line. It was beautiful.
Yeah, absolutely superb. I mean, again, Washington has put some pretty good pressure on Jimmy, but this time they just rushed those three, five offensive linemen in a three-man rush. Jimmy just drills it. You mentioned Allen, 82nd catch of his career.
Notre Dame first down, 30-yard line of Washington. Irish trailing 7-3. Closing minute of the first quarter. Pitch it to Allen. Armando Allen.
Boy.
Nice run. Good to have him back if you're an Irish fan, huh?
Absolutely. He's broken more tackles in the three games that we've seen him play, three games of this game, than I think we saw him in the first 3 years, Tom.
In the offseason, went back to Opa-locka, Florida, and got in the best shape of his career, running the steps of the stadium, being observed by his old track coach, who said he noticed he wasn't lifting his knees high enough when he ran. And, of course, in high school, Allen was the Florida State 110-meter hurdle champ.
He said he did it four times a week for about 90 minutes a session. Wildcat again.
Allen will get the snap. And keep it. Stacked up over on that side, though, by the Husky defense as they throw Allen back. I see you're avoiding calling it the leprechaun.
Yeah, that's you know, spreading around here at the South Bend campus. Charlie had nothing to do with that. Didn't like the leprechaun terminology.
Final seconds of the first quarter. There's Armando Allen as the first quarter comes to a close with Washington leading Notre Dame 7-3. And we'll return to Notre Dame Stadium after these messages from your local NBC station. You're watching Notre Dame football on NBC. MetLife is providing these views of the Notre Dame campus and the game below. MetLife provides coverage of major sporting events while also providing you with guarantees for the if in life. Visit MetLife.com today. Tom Hammond, Pat Hayden, Alex Flanagan. We begin the second quarter with Notre Dame facing a third and one at the 21-yard line of Washington, trailing 7-3. Boston with a handoff to Robert Hughes.
No, did not get it.
Stopped well short of the first down. Gage and others to hit him right away. Butler's always there, seems like, for the Huskies.
You know, Charlie Weiss has always been aggressive in these situations, but he's got a really good field goal kicker this year. You know, Nick Tausch is, when he's coming back out, he's hit his last six. And, you know, in years past, he seemed to always go for it on fourth down in this situation. But
and he said to us yesterday, though, that looking back at the Purdue game, and
wish
he had kicked the field goal. Instead of going for it on the fourth down, this time Tausch will attempt the field goal from 40 yards. He hit one earlier in the game in the first quarter. Tausch hooks it through the uprights. So Nick Tausch has two field goals, pulling the Irish closer. But less than a minute into the second quarter, Washington still in front. Back at Notre Dame Stadium, cool October afternoon, and some rain up until around noon, but none since game time. The field was covered till about 11 this morning. Nick Tausch has the ball teed, ready to kick it off after the field goal to Glennon Richardson. This will be a short kick. Taken by Richardson to the outside and out of bounds at around the 30-yard line. And now let's go to Jimmy Roberts in our New York studio for an ADT game break.
All right, Tom, thanks very much. One of the great traditions in college football, Michigan and Michigan State meeting today for the 102nd time. And after a Tate Forcey touchdown forced overtime, he threw a pick in the overtime. Here is the game winner, Larry Caper, 23 yards for the touchdown, breaking a couple of tackles. Michigan falls from the ranks of the unbeaten. Michigan State, the 6-point win. Tom, back to you.
All right, Jimmy, Sparty and company, 26-20 in overtime. Here's a first down run by Polk and Chris Polk of Washington. Did a nice first down run of about 6 yards or so.
We were talking to the offensive coordinator, Doug Nussmeier of Washington. He was talking about Chris Polk and saying, you know, we weren't sure what we were going to get with Chris Polk, but we found out that he's a pretty tough physical runner. I mean, he has been a surprise for them.
Polk, a redshirt freshman from East Valley High School, Redlands, Washington, a prep All-American there. 29 touchdowns as a senior, 2,500 yards rushing. Second down and four. Polk again. And this time the Irish ready for it. Manti Te'o was the first to hit it.
Manti Te'o, number five for the Irish, is a guy that they have a lot of expectations for here in South Bend. I mean, probably the most significant defensive recruit they've had during Charlie Weiss's era.
Certainly athletic, isn't he? You can see his speed off the edge that time. Third down. They've been very good on third down. Third and two. Jake Locker trying to set up a screen. Nothing doing. Stop back at the 30-yard line on the sack. It was Capron Lewis-Moore for a 7-yard loss.
Capron Lewis-Moore's had a very nice first half, but you're right. They were trying to set up a screen. Well read. I think it was Brian Smith who took the screen away. Trying to get the ball there. No, it was that Scott Smith, number 41, caused him to kind of tuck it and run it. And then Lewis-Moore makes the sack. Good team defense by John Tenuta's group.
So Will Mahan in punt formation for the Huskies. And Golden Tate standing back at about his 26-yard line. Well, boom, wow. Hit, wow. Tate, fair catch back at the 11-yard line. That one might have brought rain after all. 57-yard booming punt by Mahan with no return, but Lewis-Moore happy for the sack. Beautiful campus of the University of Notre Dame as the Irish trailing by a point, 12 minutes to go in the first half. Clausen identifying little linebackers, helping his line with protection. Play action fake. And a first down pass by Clausen finds Kyle Rudolph. The tight end has 5 or 6 yards on first down. You know, tackled by Trufant.
Excuse me. Jimmy Clausen just processing information so well. I mean, he was trying to get that ball to Golden Tate, but it wasn't there. Didn't force it. A little check down to his tight end to pick up 5 yards. He just, this journey of becoming a quarterback, boy, he just made remarkable strides this season.
Draw play handoff and a big gain by Robert Hughes. Hughes has a first down across the 30, gain of 14 yards.
Hey, good blocking on the right side, Trevor Robinson, Sam Young, but Robert Hughes, 68 tough yards last week. Watch the blocks, left part of the screen. Bobby Berger, too, really a key block by Berger. Robert Hughes had 68 tough, impressive yards last week, and Charlie Weiss said we've got to find a role for him. He'll get number two carries for the Irish.
He said he'd been lobbying for tailback carries, and he's going to get some.
You know, it's amazing how that's used again, how quickly a running back gets healthy when the guy behind him plays so well. So Hughes plays really well last week. Armando Allen shows up today to start.
Saw Jimmy Clausen a little gimpy earlier when he was hit. Alex, is he okay?
Tommy doesn't seem to be moving around or too affected by that turf toe, but it's something he's going to be playing with all season long. As the trainer explained to me, turf toe is bending back your finger, and this part right here, Tom, the joint of your finger is what's affected. I'm going to give it back to you for a second, Tom.
All right, Clausen hands off to Allen. Armando Allen tackled by Court Dennison. Alex?
All right, Tom. So what Jimmy did was he bent his toe back like this. The joint right here in the big toe is what's affected and is what gives him pain. So what they're trying to do is not allow this toe to bend bend backwards at all, and thus they have a full metal plate in his shoe. But Pat, as you know, it's almost impossible to step back, plant, and then drive without bending your toe backwards.
Yeah, you're right. That is your plant foot, and you know, you get all the oomph on throws off that right foot as you release the ball.
However, today he's hit 5 of 6 to 5 different receivers, facing a 3 and 6, bad toe and all. Across the middle, a strike to Golden Tate. First down, Notre Dame.
Good protection again for Jimmy Clausen. Scans the field. They, you know, really spread the field out with all those wide receivers Notre Dame has. And Golden Tate just kind of settles down in the middle. Watch him. He's right there in the slot. Free safety can't get there in time. And it was really the protection that allowed Clausen to make it easy throw to Golden Tate.
Gain of 14 yards. First down. Justin Glenn made the stop.
There's the right, yeah, the right foot as he plants off it.
From midfield, first down. Tate in motion. Make the handoff. Here's Rudolph all by himself. The big man rambles to the 20-yard line. That's a gain of 30 yards.
Well, you know, you worry about Golden Tate so much. We said at the very beginning of the show, you try to put two people on Golden Tate. What do? They throw it to the big old tight end, 6'6" Kyle Rudolph, who, you know, is averaging about 15 yards a catch, which is pretty good for a tight end. I just don't understand why people don't try to jam him at the line of scrimmage. Tommy, they had a free release off the line of scrimmage.
There's the sparkling numbers by Kyle Rudolph this season.
They got double coverage on Golden Tate on this play right now.
It's a play action fake, and Clausen looks for Rudolph again. Chase from the pocket. There's a flag down as he whips it to Rudolph for what would be a touchdown if it stands.
Clausen saw the double coverage, goes right to the tight end. That was the plan.
Pretty hard to miss, big Tommy.
Yeah. Number 72 on the offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay first down.
There's a hold by Paul Duncan.
We've been throwing some love his way, too, right? The offensive line did a real nice job of protecting Jimmy Clausen, but Paul gets caught. That guy, Kyle Rudolph, we talked about him playing it almost like basketball. Didn't he have like 600 rebounds in high school as a basketball player?
Yeah, 1,000 points and 600 rebounds. Three-time conference player of the year in basketball. So he just posts up those smaller receivers as it would be and throw to the big guy with those huge hands that he has. Tate. Golden Tate draws a crowd at the 15-yard line. That's a 14-yard gain. Look at a big chunk of sod.
Yeah. Yeah, Golden Tate, number 23, using, we said, four different ways. This time is what they call their X receiver, their split end.
Look at the cushion given him by Trufant, the big freshman.
Right, right.
That came to make the tackle.
Yeah, you're right. If they don't double cover, if he's double cover, he's going to be up tight in his face. He's off. So Jimmy sees that, throws it to him, and says, hey, you try to tackle him. Again, we see Rudolph as kind of a wide receiver up top.
Clausen has hit 7 in a row. Throws it away as he was being chased.
Heads up play.
It was. Smart play with Trufant on the blitz bearing down on him. So they came with a corner blitz. Forces Clausen to throw it away. There's Trufant, the freshman. His brother Marcus was All-American at Washington State. Now plays for the Seahawks in the NFL. And Desmond is just a freshman. So you figure Notre Dame would have dead aim on him. And the Washington coach is telling us, we don't mind. We think he is up to it.
Yeah, Nick Holden, the defensive coordinator, said he is a fantastic corner as a true freshman. And he's up here.
Third down and 6. And Clausen takes a timeout. Play clock ticking down, and Jimmy Clausen spends a Notre Dame timeout. It'll be 3rd and 6 when we come back to Notre Dame Stadium. Seven and a half to go, second quarter. Washington leads Notre Dame 7-6. Irish facing a 3rd down and 6 from the 16 of the Huskies. Clausen. Nobody open. Now lost it for Rudolph in the end zone, a dangerous pass, which Trufant nearly intercepted.
Well, you're right. That was a good play by Trufant. You know, that's one that Jimmy has generally been throwing those balls away. But he said the true freshman is going to be outstanding. That's what the coaches think. What a great play. Golden Tate, number 23, again open early in this route. Wanted the ball there. Jimmy didn't see it. And he said, give it to me, stick it to me. But he has such confidence in Kyle Rudolph going out now, jumping the defender's time.
34-yard field goal attempt by Nick Tausch. He's hit two already. And the third one to give the Irish the lead is good. 9-7 Notre Dame. Three field goals and three possessions for the Irish. Light rain falling down as Notre Dame has taken the lead for the first time today over Coach Sarkisian and the Huskies. Mark, there's the rain.
That light rain is more than light rain.
Light,
yes.
Tausch to kick off for Notre Dame.
When's the last time you saw a kicker wear eye black?
Makes you feel like part of the game. Pat, come on. And he has hit eight straight field goals now for the Irish. Their only points today on his field goals. Kickoff taken by Richardson. But Richardson lost all his momentum, kind of chopped his steps, and was taken down at the 25-yard line.
Mike Anello on the tackle.
Mike Anello, the special teams whiz for the Irish. And, of course, I guess every game Notre Dame plays these days is a close game, but a little disturbing for Coach Charlie Weiss, I guess, the fact that they've not been able to put the ball into the end zone on those three possessions where they settled for the field goal.
Yeah, he was talking to us this week as, hey, you know, we've won some close ball games, but we want to take the next step. And that, for him, what that meant is, hey, kind of knock someone out early. So that's Bobby Berger, who's had a real nice day blocking from the fullback position.
Yeah, playing tight end and fullback for the Irish.
But he said, hey, we need to take the next step as a team. So the Irish defense has played pretty well. Remember, Jake Locker is a really capable quarterback.
Gets the play call from his coach. A little last-minute check of the armband into the huddle on first down from the 28-yard line of the Huskies. Locker lost it up high, and Goodwin looked like he just padded and dropped it. Sergio Brown defending him, but looked like it was right in his hands.
Yeah, it just absolutely dropped. Perfect touch by Locker. You know, before Coach Sarkisian got a hold of him, he was less than a 50% completion thrower. Oh. That was an absolutely perfect throw by Locker. He's completing almost 60% of his throws this year. That's the goal that Steve Sarkisian has for him.
Yeah, he's at 58.1% coming into the game with 1,002 yards, six touchdowns, and three interceptions.
And he was 49%, I think, 2 years ago.
Steps up in the pocket, throws another strike that's dropped. James Johnson.
Speaking about strikes, Jake Locker is a heck of an athlete. You know, we talked about him leading the team almost 1,000 yards in rushing a couple of years ago, but drafted by the Angels. Great baseball player as well.
Pitcher and outfielder. He was the 3A State Player of the Year in Washington. Never played for the Huskies, but this past August signed by the Los Angeles Angels, who drafted him in the 10th round as a center fielder. Third down and 10 for Locker. Scrambles. And upended as he crosses the 35, short of the first down by Brian Smith.
Well, that's a good tackle by Brian Smith, because Jake Locker had a big old head of steam, didn't he?
Yeah.
Talked about, we're just showing what an athlete he is. Almost 230 pounds. He's become more comfortable in the pocket, but this is what he does best. And a heck of a tackle, and they force another punt by Washington. Leading tackler in the game for the Irish, amazingly, is their talented freshman, Manti Te'o.
Here's Will Mahan, who boomed one last time, 57 yards.
Put a flight attendant on that thing last time.
Tate, another fair catch call, and taken at the 26-yard line, where the Irish will start with 6:09 on the clock. Notre Dame leading Washington by 2-9-7. Two-point game at Notre Dame. That's Nick Holt, the defensive coordinator of the Huskies. His defense back out on the field. Holt came with Coach Sarkisian from USC to Seattle. Clawson sets up a screen to Allen.
Good play by Trufant.
What penetration. Yeah. Trufant is having a first half, isn't he?
He is. You know, the coaches said they're going to pick on him, but we're ready. Ready for him. This is a guy they said he's going to develop into an all-Pac-10 corner at some point in his career. Keeps it up and do it as a freshman.
Alex?
You guys, if you watch, the coaches are on him this entire game, really coaching him. Earlier in the game, he was faked out by a wide receiver, and the DB's coach told him, just don't think too much, but they do really love his athleticism. But watch, they're helping him a lot into getting him in the right position during this game.
There's a golden tape right now.
Got a human cheat sheet over there, the coaches. Here's Allen. To the 30-yard line.
You know a lot about those cheat sheets, don't you, Tom?
Donald Butler chased him down.
There he is, the maniacal defensive coordinator. Doesn't look like he's the kind of guy that orders much Chardonnay, doesn't he? Yeah. Nick Caldwell, he has done a great job with his defense. He says, hey, we've got some pretty good players, but we really need to upgrade, particularly in, you know, depth in the defensive line. They did a great job at USC, and they did the same at Washington.
Third down and 7. Parsons in the gun. Tries to get it to Allen, and that is could be a backward
pass.
It's a backward pass, it'll be a Husky touchdown. Trufant, who else? Still waiting. It is a touchdown. Backward pass picked up by Trufant for the touchdown for the Huskies.
You're right. They did it against Stanford, but Mason Foster, number 40, the linebacker, read the screen. He forced the running back deep. That afford, you know, Clawson tried to lob it over Foster, and that's when it became a backward pass. Number 40 in the right part of the screen, he does a great job reading it. And they're going to have a review upstairs, but Desmond Trufant.
Red line would be the line of scrimmage. That's unofficial. And a backward pass looked definitely backward pass.
Absolutely.
17-yard TD return.
Up high. That is without doubt a backward pass.
And Clawson was standing in front of the 20, and the ball landed inside the 20.
Justin Glenn returned a similar play last week for, I think it was 51 yards against Stanford.
Times you see that, two straight games, a backward pass for a touchdown.
This is it. First and only.
Ryan O'Kane is going to converse with the replay officials upstairs. I think they will confirm it is a backward pass and a Husky touchdown.
After further review, the pass is confirmed to be backwards.
Yep.
Touchdown.
And so Jimmy's, yeah, that ball lands behind where Jimmy threw it.
Yep.
And Trufant is right there to pick it up.
So Jimmy was standing in front of the 20, and the ball lines inside the 20.
And Jimmy, where he throws it, is right here. And again, behind him, Trufant is there to make the play.
Touchdown, Huskies, as Trufant been the hero of the game.
In the story, absolutely.
Bolt for the point after. It's good. So, not only rain, but lightning strikes at Notre Dame Stadium as the backward pass results in the Husky touchdown, and Washington goes back on top. In fact, their defense has held Notre Dame without a touchdown, holding the Irish to 3 field goals on those 3 drives. The Huskies got a touchdown on their first possession of the game. The Notre Dame defense had pretty well shut them down, but then a heads-up play by the freshman Trufant.
Yeah, Trufant, to me, has been really the story of this first half. He's kind of guarded Golden Tate reasonably well, kept him out of the end zone, and done obviously a nice job on that return for a touchdown. And you know, Nick Holt's defense is kind of keeping their team in the game, because offensively, the Huskies really haven't done a lot. I would say the Notre Dame defense has done pretty well as well.
I think Nick Holt was happy with that. You think he was yelling at his freshman quarterback, too?
Yeah, he might. He doesn't do it often, but this is the guy he really likes. You were right? Yeah.
I think he'll have champagne instead of Chardonnay.
Well, the coach together, he and Steve Sarkisian, down south in USC, and Sark not as maniacal as Nick Holt.
Here's the kickoff by Folk. Theo Riddick spun around and taken down at the 20-yard line. Good special teams coverage by the Huskies. Notre Dame takes over with 4.5 minutes to go till halftime. Nate Fellner made the special teams tackle. Get live scores and news on your phone, plus iPhone users can watch live NBC Sports coverage of Notre Dame games. To find out how, text the word IRISH to 51515. Message and data rates apply.
Tom, remember Nick Holt? We were talking to him this week, and he was saying, you know, we inherited an 0-12 team, but we expect to turn this thing around this year. They're not waiting, and they've already upset number three USC and given the Irish all they can handle here in the first half.
And you know, Clawson probably should have thrown that one away, too. He threw it when there was no way he was going to complete it. And that's when he should have zipped into the stands. This one zips to Armando Allen.
Right over the outstretched hands of Talia Crichton, number one. Yeah, just kind of a little. I mean, sometimes you have to put some mustard on it, like you did with the touchdown pass against Purdue at the end of the game. Sometimes you lob it right over the outstretched hands of the 6'3 freshman Crichton. So he can zip it, he can have some touch.
First down line today brought to you by Xerox. Armando Allen. Didn't get much, but looks like he has enough for the first down. Daniel Teonesim made the tackle. First time we've called his name today, and he is an outstanding player.
Yeah, Nick Holt was saying he's probably the best defensive lineman in the Pac-10 in his estimation. He said he's never had a player work harder than Daniel Teonesim does.
And he beats the coaches in to look at the tape of the opponents and looks at the opposing defense as well, just to see if he can pick anything up as a tip. Clawson scrambling around, bad toe and all, and finds an open receiver, Golden Tate. And Tate shaking tacklers to the 25 and still on his feet for the touchdown. Reception of the season, 67 yards. Point after by Nick Towns. It is good.
Hey, Tom, you know, this offensive line of Notre Dame, you almost have to feel for them and their mothers. Because over the last couple of years, the offensive line has taken a lot of abuse. But, boy, they have given Jimmy Clawson great protection today. And you're always going to be looking for a guy, number 23, Golden Tate. If you're Jimmy Clawson and you're in trouble and you're scrambling, he's up at the top of the screen. He was open early. Jimmy couldn't get it to him because he was scrambling. Finally, he sees him wide open. Now, watch how hard he is to tackle. You see the speed. And then he's just really hard to bring down. From running back, from a wide receiver to running back. And 67 yards later, he's in the end zone. And he's the guy that's going to continue to give the Irish the big plays without Michael Floyd out of the lineup. Even though you know he's going to get the ball, they still find a way to get him. That's the beauty of Charlie Weiss, I think.
So the first touchdown of the game for the Irish is Clawson and Tate. Celebrate a 67-yard touchdown as the Irish go 78 yards on three plays. And they recapture the lead. As Tausch will kick it to Glennon Richardson. And there's the kick. Richardson. Flag is down. Richardson can't get outside. Tackled at about the 26-yard line.
Block in the back.
illegal block in the back. Number 20 on the return team. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
So Justin Glenn was called for the penalty, and the Huskies will be backed up at their own 10-yard line. And now the big set-off crowd getting into it. Locker began hitting his first five passes, but he's missed his last four now. First down pass. Locker's going downfield, man open, and it's caught by Goodwin.
Well, this time he caught it. Same route. Remember they ran that wheel route earlier to Goodwin? It was a perfect throw, and he dropped it, Tom. Come right back to it. And this is the guy that really made it happen here. Right here. Again, just a little bit of a wheel. Yeah, absolutely a pick play. You know, they rarely call it the pick plays. But good throw again by Jake Locker.
30-yard gain. First down at the 40. And as he did a moment ago, Locker appears to be changing the play. Polk. Falls forward for a yard. Tough sledding up the middle against the Irish defense. And there's Manti Te'o again to make first contact.
Never mind, Te'o's really leading their leading tackler right now for the Irish.
Hurry up offense for the Huskies. Locker still has plenty of time. 20 seconds on the play clock. It's a handoff. Polk hit in the backfield and dropped. Looked like John Ryan was the first to get there. Then he had a lot of company.
Kerry Neal helped him as well from his defensive end position. Well, what a difference they have played up front. They're down four guys from Notre Dame over the last 2.5 games, Tom. They were gashed those first couple games to run, particularly against Michigan, Nevada. They have really responded over the last couple weeks. It was Neal and then Ryan to get him down.
Now coming up at halftime, the U.S. Bank Notre Dame halftime show. Jimmy Roberts in New York with all the scores and highlights from college football's top 25. Jimmy will be joined in studio by not only Peter King, but also Mike Florio of Pro Football Talk, which of course is now partnered with NBCSports.com.
And that is Randy Hart with a headset on, the coach from Notre Dame. He spent 21 years at the University of Washington, now in his first year at Notre Dame. Been coaching 40 years, 37 of those as a defensive line coach. Wasn't retained by Steve Sarkisian, and very happy to be at Notre Dame.
Yeah, he was really high in his praise of this university and had nothing bad to say about his years, which he enjoyed thoroughly in Seattle. And still, though he's a veteran, had such great enthusiasm as we talked to him.
Yeah, he did. Like a kid.
Yeah. Third down and 12.
Important down right now for the Huskies.
Locker takes the low snap through a pass that was nearly picked off, intended for Curse. The pass was low and was never going to get to Curse. It was closest maybe to Brian Smith.
Yeah, part of that, Kerry Neal put another good rush on Jake Locker. So Jimmy Clausen's going to get the ball back with over 2 minutes and still a timeout remaining. And as we saw last week, the Irish are pretty good with just a few seconds in either half.
Yeah, Jimmy Clausen directing that drive against Purdue. The stuff of Notre Dame legend. One of those game-winning drives. Here's Mahan punting it away. Another fair catch by Tate. Slides in. He is a baseball player at the 25-yard line. And now it's time for our Liberty Mutual Legends of the Game. arguably the greatest coach in college football history. Newt Rockne coached at Notre Dame from 1918 to 1930, during which time the Irish won 3 national championships. And with his grandchildren on hand yesterday, Rockne was honored with the unveiling of a bronze sculpture that depicts the former Irish coach in his trademark sweatshirt and baseball pants. Outside the Notre Dame Stadium, Newt Rockne. It's surprising that there wasn't a statue of Newt Rockne at the stadium. The house that Rockne built, as Shaq Evans shakes the tackler.
Well, they do have a bust of Newt Rockne on campus as well. The students like to fool around with. Touch his nose as they come from.
For good luck.
To and from class.
Gain of 13 yards on that play to the freshman Evans before he's tackled by Court Dennison. Hurry up for the Irish. Boston through the hands of Allen and intercepted by Butler.
Yeah, Donald Butler this year has been kind of a turnover machine. Interception against USC, forced a fumble against USC, and now an interception right now against the Irish. Ball that probably should have been caught.
Yeah, through the hands of Allen right to Butler.
Armando Allen has been a terrific receiver over these 3 years. Just went right through his slippery hands, and Donald Butler right there knows what to do with it.
So the Huskies take over now at the 34-yard line of the Irish. Notre Dame leads by 2. Jake Locker on first down sends Goodwin in motion. Locker hit, ball's loose, Notre Dame has it.
Ethan Johnson, I think, got there to him first, and then a teammate recovered it. Ethan Johnson playing inside, Tom. Remember, we were talking to Randy Hart yesterday, said, hey, played in the edge as a defensive end in high school, and then last year getting used to playing tackle, and boy, did he make a nice play there.
Have there been some tremendous momentum swings here in this game?
Absolutely. Watch number 9 kind of fight his way through the backside and get to Locker.
And then Ryan recovers.
Yeah. In perfect weather for Ethan Johnson. He told us a couple weeks ago, what'd you miss about Portland? He said the rain.
From Portland, Oregon. And said he actually did miss the rain. So he's right at home today, as are the Huskies. Spot the ball at the Irish 40. With a minute 29 on the clock, first half.
Two-man rush.
And still, Golden Tate finds a spot and is right at the first down marker.
Nick Tausch's longest kick, 46 yards, so they need to get out to about the 28 to 29 yard line to give Nick a good shot.
10-yard gain on that one, and close enough that they're going to measure it, I think, or is it timeout?
I think Washington may have called timeout.
Yeah, well, the Huskies called the timeout.
Well, we talked at the very beginning of the show that Golden Tate was going to line up in a lot of different positions, Tom, and indeed he has. I have a 5 or 6 position. This is what they call Z, a flanker, because he can go in motion. This is the very first play of the game. Second play of the game, he lined up at split end, X. So he's played Z, he's played X, 2 different positions. He was a decoy there. Then Kenny was in motion where they throw him the ball this time, trying to find a way. Starts out at fullback, but watch 3 guys go after him, and he leads, you know, that allows Kyle Rudolph to come wide open. And then just a moment ago, the touchdown to Golden Tate. So, you know, Charlie Weiss moving him around is paying dividends for the second week in a row.
So Washington took the timeout. They have 2 remaining. Notre Dame with 1 timeout left. And a minute 22 on the clock.
Well, where's Waldo, Tom? He's up at the top, Golden Tate. Looks like they're going to try to double him with Trufant in a safety. He's up there now.
First down. Paulson has hit 7 of his 8 pass attempts on first down. Chased. And dives down for a loss on the play. And it was Trufant, or no, it was Butler that came in, closing down on Clausen, causing him to scramble and eventually just diving to the ground. Timeout Notre Dame. Their final timeout comes with a minute 11 on the clock. So a minute 11 left in this first half, and you got to wonder where you can find Golden Tate. He's the big playmaker, and that's probably what Washington is talking about right now.
We talked to Nick Holt, the defensive coordinator. He says, I'm not stupid. I'm going to roll my coverage to Golden Tate. And, you know, even when you do, it creates other opportunities that we've seen for Kyle Rudolph, other backs as well. So even if he's not catching the ball, I mean, I think he influences the game.
So the Irish, again, they've shown us that they can march down the field quickly, as they did against Purdue last week.
With Floyd out, 8 quarters played. He's caught 15 balls, 284 yards, 2 touch. Surprising numbers to me, really. I think that the beauty of what Charlie Weiss has tried to do with him is move him around, because you would have thought they would have shut him out, teams, double cover him.
That's Michael Floyd. Michael Floyd, who is out with a broken collarbone, but has taken on the role of somewhat as player coach, as he has been especially coaching up guys like Shaq Evans, who is the freshman receiver. Clausen throws it away.
See, he just saved 20 yards there. Washington coaches say it should be grounding, but I thought he was outside the tackle box. That's the rule.
And got the ball to the line of scrimmage.
He's outside the tackle box. Get it to the line of scrimmage. It's not grounding.
Mason Foster was bearing down on Jimmy Clausen.
Saved at least 15 yards in that play. So have another look at it. It's a good look at the tackle box.
And remember, Clausen, he's not out. Very mobile anyway.
Yep.
And
moves like the Chrysler building.
Third down, 15. Clausen falls down, slipped on the wet turf, and is down at the 35-yard line.
Theo Nessum down two for the Huskies.
11-yard loss on the play, and Washington quickly calls a timeout, stops the clock with 53 seconds.
Well, you know, interesting. That's the kind of confidence I think Steve Sarkisian has in Jake Locker. I mean, ordinarily, hey, let the clock run out, get into halftime down two, right?
So it'll be fourth down for the Irish with 58 seconds on the clock. And I think we're going to see the freshman Ben Turk on for his first career punt. Meanwhile, MetLife is providing today's aerial coverage. Visit MetLife.com to learn more about the blimp program's 20-plus year history. MetLife guarantees for the if in life.
How many of the 80,000 are discouraged by the rain, you think?
None.
None.
All sitting here.
They love it.
And there is a look at Ben Turk, the freshman from Davie, Florida, who is set to, in not the best of conditions.
Yeah, they benched their former punter, Moust, who just was not getting the job done. And Charlie Weiss said it yesterday, I've seen enough of him. Moust, I'm going with my freshman Turk.
It is the first punt by Notre Dame today. Fogerson calls for the fair catch, makes it at the 25-yard line of the Huskies, and they'll have 51 seconds after the 39-yard punt, the first of Turk's career.
Okay, there's Sarkisian.
It's got to be comforting to know you've got number 10 out there.
Absolutely.
Huh?
Although, I tell you, the Irish defense have done a pretty good job of bottling him down. You know, he's only 6 of 11 for 70 yards passing, and rushing, he really hasn't been that much of a factor. Did have that one touchdown, but 6 carries for just 10 yards.
John Tenuta surveying the scene. We'll see if he comes after Jake Locker. Screen pass. Polk got not much, 5 yards or so.
Dan Lewis Moore, Capron Lewis Moore, number 89, defensive lineman for the Irish, did a good job. That could have gone for 15 yards.
Second down. Locker being chased. Rips it down the field, and it is caught for a first down. There's a penalty marker down field. DeAndre Goodwin made the catch right at the sideline. Good job by DeAndre.
It's the back judge who threw it very late.
Ineligible lineman downfield, number 71 on the offense, 5-yard penalty, replay second down.
All costly penalty by Coy Hobbin.
To see how good Jake Locker has out of the pocket. You know, the coaches say he's probably the second fastest guy in their team. And I was amazed when the coaches were saying that he could probably play six different positions for the Huskies. I think they have him in the right one, though.
Yeah. So now 25 seconds on the clock. Still a timeout left for Washington. Second down and 10 from their own 25. Going deep. Now caught and then a hit. Good one held on somehow or other. 28-yard gain.
Terrific catch by DeAndre Goodwin. You know, he dropped an easy one, but caught earlier, but caught a tough one. And you know that was lobby. He knew he was going to take a shot.
Mr. Dependable trying to knock it loose.
Yeah.
Locker pumps once. Goes again across the middle, and it's caught by Curse.
Yeah. They've got one timeout. They should use it to take a field goal.
24-yard gain on that one. 7 seconds on the clock, which stops.
But they have a timeout.
Stops with the first down. Locker spikes the ball to stop it with 2 seconds left. I don't know what the point of that was.
No, they had a timeout left.
Yeah.
I have no idea why they did that, but good, you know, late drive by Jake Locker. Just kind of hummed that ball in there. Again, a year ago, he would have run on those.
Yeah.
You know, but he's coached to kind of hang in there in the pocket. And you see the kind of arm strength that he has.
So Folk will attempt a field goal. He's hit 6 of 7, including the game winner against USC. This is a 40-yard attempt to give Washington the lead at halftime. Eric Folk sends it on its way. And it is good.
Good closing drive by the Huskies, led by Jake Locker. Just drilled a couple balls.
Exciting first half at Notre Dame Stadium. The Huskies and the Irish. Let's go to Alex.
Crazy, Charlie, a crazy few last minutes in this game. You turn the ball over, get it back then, but unable to really capitalize. What have they been doing to you offensively?
Oh, no, they're playing. Well, what they're doing is they're dropping their ends out, dropping their ends out wide on, you know, on the outside routes, you know, forcing you to throw the ball in the middle of the field, which is where we're trying to throw it.
You told me coming into this game that the key would be containing Jake Locker. How are you doing at that?
Well, I mean, the defense has done a pretty good job. We went up on offense. They gave up 10 points in the first half. We didn't need to do a better job on offense.
All right, Charlie on his way into the locker room, Tom.
All right, Alex. So Steve Sarkisian and the Huskies, as he looks at that field goal on the last play of the first half, go through to give Washington the lead. At intermission, it's Washington 17 and Notre Dame 16. Now stay tuned for the U.S. Bank Notre Dame Halftime Show. Don't forget, the halftime performance of the Notre Dame band can be seen at NBCSports.com. Now let's go to Jimmy Roberts in our New York studio. Some of the inspiring work done by the University of Notre Dame as we look at the first half stats. See that Notre Dame outrushed and outpassed them. Total yards, but the two turnovers,
yes.
One of them went for a touchdown.
They only had three coming into the game total.
Here's the second half kick by Eric Folk, taken by Theo Riddick. Riddick hit and falls forward to the 20-yard line and just across it. And that's where the Irish will put it in play, as Jimmy Clausen.
Looks like he's going with a glove on his left hand, too, Tom. Didn't see that in the first half.
Well, that's the result of the rain, I would guess. See if that helps hold on to a slippery football.
A lot of quarterbacks actually, you know, playing with it on the right hand, throwing with the glove these days.
And what is it, Kurt Warner wears gloves all the time?
Matter what
hands. Yeah.
I mean, they have that tackiness to them, which you think you'd love.
21-yard line, first down, Irish. Clausen fakes the handoff, throws the pass, and it's caught on the fly by Golden Tate. He shakes one tackler, and here he goes again. Tate racing for the end zone, and out of bounds at the 2. Desmond Trufant chased him down and saved the touchdown. 77 yards.
And 141 yards of total offense in the first half. And where's Waldo starts the second half on another beautiful note. Injured Washington player down too, Tom. But, boy, you know what? It's amazing. Even if you know he's going to get it, but I think the amazing thing to me is how good he is after the catch. And he starts as that wide receiver, then he's out running people. Remember, a sprinter in high school down in Tennessee, where he won the state 100 and 200-meter races.
Well, he's just, the freshman, Trufant, took a good angle to get there and prevent the touchdown. But
how about over 200 yards of total offense already when we just started the second half?
And this one, 77 yards, is his career best.
Well, he's got everything. He's got good hands. He's got real power when he has the ball in his hands. And he's just got a nose for the end zone, which starts about the 40-yard line.
The injured Husky back at about the 45-yard line is Justin Glenn, their free safety.
He's a guy that Nick Holt was very, very high on. Just got transferred to free safety. Was a corner. He's only been a safety for about two weeks.
He'll be replaced by Greg Walker.
Here's number 20, middle of the screen. And his teammates just rolled into him.
Placed by Greg Walker, 5'10", 197, redshirt freshman from Bellflower, California, at free safety. So first and goal for the Irish. Armando Allen. Stacked up short of the goal line. Charlie Weiss calling a goal line play, red zone play in the rain at Notre Dame Stadium in a 17-16 game, and the Irish just getting a 77-yard pass completion to Golden Tate.
Well, Steve Sarkisian said, hey, we knew Golden Tate was the guy, and we're going to double cover him, but he still hadn't even stopped him.
Bobby Berger playing fullback. Armando Allen is the tailback. Ragone in motion, fake the handoff. Clawson rolling, throws it away. Good coverage by the Huskies.
Yeah, you know, Jimmy Clawson forced one in the first half, but that one, again, just throw it away. Gets you two more downs at it. Guy Rudolph, always the kind of the target down here inside number nine, right side of the screen. Always the target inside the 10-yard line.
Got too close together, didn't they? There's three of them all right there together.
Good coverage by Avaya, number 41.
Now third down and goal from the two. Allen hit in the backfield. Court Dennison was the first man to hit him as he got penetration.
Yeah, Court Dennison filling in for E.J. Savannah. Number 31's had a pretty good first half and a good start in the second half.
So on three occasions in the first half, the Irish had to settle for field goals, and here it is again.
Yeah, number 31, just a guy that Steve Sarkisian says, you know, just does things right.
Nick Tausch, who's hit 8 field goals in a row after missing his first, will attempt a 21-yarder. Tausch with his 4th field goal of the game. Irish jockey back on top. 19-17. From soggy Notre Dame Stadium, Tom Hammond, Pat Hayden, Alex Flanagan. 4th field goal of the game by Nick Tausch, and ready to kick it off.
Well, I think Alex Flanagan's pretty wet, don't you? Soggy Alex Flanagan.
Short kickoff. Richardson.
Buffing
out the ball. And Washington, like Washington covered it.
Yeah, let's go back to that third down play, Tom, that, you know, Court Dennison did such a great job. This is a kid who grew up a Notre Dame fan in Salt Lake City, kind of subbing now, but actually just kind of shoots on a blitz. No one blocks him, runs right back by a fullback, and forces the field goal. I mean, that's a 4-point swing, and Charlie Weiss really unhappy with his offensive line for not picking up that blitz.
So the Irish settle for the field goal, but they do regain the lead, 19-17.
And Tom, excuse me, remember that saving tackle by Desmond Trufant that forced the field goal attempt. I mean, that is a four-point swing there.
77-yard pass to Tate. He chased him down at the two, and they make themselves a three. Here's Locker. He's going for seven. He's got a man wide open. And it's over the head of Jermaine Kearse. Well, we'll see how soggy Scooter is. Alex?
Hey, Tom. Well, the rain finally letting up a little bit down here, but this field is really, really slippery, so watch out for injuries. Justin Glenn, the free safety of Washington, is going to be taken into the locker room right now. They're going to x-ray his fibula. They believe he might have broken it. And, of course, as you guys mentioned, the other freshman now backing him up.
You find a dry spot, Scooter?
I'm trying, Tom. It is wet.
It's dry up here, Alex.
On second and 10, Chris Polk bursting free for a moment and then pounding his way for a first down.
Yeah, just kind of dragging four Irish defenders the extra 3 yards to pick up the first. Powerful run by Chris Polk.
Gained 12 yards.
Okay, this is the guy that we said the coaches were surprised how powerful he was. Good block by Ben Oside, the left tackle. And Ryan Tolar, the center, giving him some help as well. Powerful run.
First down, Huskies, their own 48-yard line. And Washington has taken a timeout. Timeout, Huskies. They trail Notre Dame by two. Rain letting up a bit at Notre Dame Stadium. We're in the third quarter, 12:09 on the clock. 19-17 Notre Dame. Washington with a first down at their own 48-yard line. Jake Locker pitching on the stretch to Chris Polk. Out of bounds at the Irish 49-yard line.
So a pretty good play by Manti Te'o, that freshman we talked about. A guy didn't make the tackle, but took on two blockers and cleared the way for one of his teammates to make the tackle. Manti's number five, left part of the screen. See, he took a wide receiver and a defensive or an offensive tackle on, and then allowed Ethan Johnson to make the play.
Shotgun on second down. Fulgerson lowers his head and pounds to the 40-yard line. It's a Washington first down. Joey Fulgerson catches it for 9 yards, his first reception of the game.
Yeah, interesting guy. Was a starting safety a year ago. Steve Sarkisian moved him over on offense and moves him around a little bit.
Today's first down line brought to you by Xerox. Down Huskies driving at the Notre Dame 40 in a two-point game. Locker's in the shotgun on first down.
Same play
to the other side. Kearse. And another nice game for the Huskies. He worked on one side. Why not call it on the other? Robert Blint finally tripped him up after he gained 13.
Well, you know, Steve Sarkisian is not only the head coach, he's the play caller as well. And I've watched him for a long time. I think one of the great play callers in college football. And if he finds something that's going to work, he's going to keep running it. Just ran two successive little screens to those wide receivers. Really, really mixes it up.
Now from the 27. Locker has a man open, and it's caught by Fulgerson. Got rid of one tackler and then out of bounds at the 20-yard line. Chased out by Sergio Brown.
Well, he ran two bubble screens, and then he was trying to pump it and then go deep. That was taken away, so Jake Locker does a nice job of dumping it off to Fulgerson. Good drive here by the Huskies. Team that really has just changed its ways.
Dramatically.
0-12 a year ago, Tom. Just absolutely changed its ways.
There's the quarterback comparison, that battle of the QBs that we have been talking about all afternoon. Blitz comes, and Locker keeps it on a quarterback draw and bulldozes bulldozing his way down to the 6 yard line.
Bulldozing, huh, Tom? That's a good word. It's a good adjective. Or is that a verb?
Yeah, well, 14
it's a verb.
Yards.
14 yards. But again, it was Darren Wall saved the tackle. Good lead block by Polk and Tovar, the center, again.
And the stiff arm and the bulldoze. That is a verb, the way he does it.
It is. And he just, you know, he doesn't run like a quarterback, does he? What an athlete.
First and goal from the Notre Dame 6. Chris Polk runs into a bunch of Irish and slammed down.
Ethan Johnson first. He's having a heck of a game. Ethan Johnson, number 9.
Hit him first, and then Lewis Moore slammed into the turf.
Yeah, those two guys have really done pretty well inside. There's Ethan, a guy that blocked an extra point against Michigan State, which may turn out to be one of the big plays of the season for them. You know, Ethan just kind of blew through his guy. That allowed Lewis Moore to finish him off.
It's a loss of a yard. Second and goal from the 7.
Well, and then we ran a quarterback draw for a touchdown the last play. And when you get spread them out like this, you really have to worry about Rocker as a runner.
Empty backfield. Looking to throw, and he does for the touchdown. A flag is down. Jermaine Kearse catches it for the score as we check the penalty marker.
Jake Locker was always a good running quarterback.
Pass interference, number 2 on the defense.
Okay.
Italy has declined, touchdown.
But, you know, he's a guy that was a really good running quarterback. The boys, he had developed as a player now, as an accurate thrower. Just kind of hung in the pocket, threw it right out in front of the receiver, Kearse. I can see why Steve Sarkisian says we got to get Kearse in the game more.
Polk's extra point is good. And the Huskies respond to the Notre Dame field goal with a touchdown and another lead change. Kearse caught the touchdown pass from Locker. Huskies back on top. Huskies go 64 yards on 9 plays. Jake Locker hit 4 of 5 through the air and ran for 14 yards on the drive. Kicks it off for Washington. Theo Riddick. Flag back up field as Riddick was hit hard.
Yeah, the other thing about that drive for the Huskies, it chewed up about 4 minutes, Tom. That's what usually Notre Dame does.
There for Washington.
Kick on the offside by the Huskies.
That's a break for the Irish because they were down inside the 15.
So the offside call and a redo. Jimmy Clausen getting some words from Charlie Weiss. It's been a quarterback duel that we anticipated between Clausen and Locker, two friends, by the way, who have spoken to each other during the week and greeted each other as they came onto the field for warm-ups today.
Both of them with what they tell us, chocolate labs.
Yeah. Cool. 10 is Locker's.
10 is a very clever name.
Folk to kick it. Kick. Riddick. To the 35, so much better field position after the penalty for Notre Dame.
Hey, let's go back to that drive that chewed up 4 minutes. And Jake Locker, the history major from Washington, watch what he did. I mean, bubble screen out here to Kearse, kind of getting that drive started. Then the powerful run on the draw by Locker, taking the ball down inside the 5 yard line. And then the payoff play. The touchdown as he hung in the pocket and drilled it to Kearse. Terrific drive. 9 plays, eating up 4 minutes, ending in a touchdown.
Now Clausen's turn, starting from his own 35. Empty backfield, five wide receivers. Protection, pretty good. And he finds Rudolph for a short gain. Across the 40 to the 41-yard line, a six-yard gain on first down. Mason Foster made the tackle of big Kyle Rudolph.
Two head coaches, but both head coaches play callers. Charlie Weiss took over the reins again this year to call plays. Steve Sarkisian decided he was going to call them when he got his first head coaching job. And he's got about 120 plays on that sheet of his. And you have that very good eyesight if you're a quarterback as you look down at those small numbers.
From the shotgun, send Allen in motion. Caution. Caught on the rebound by Tate.
You know, he's just a 20-yard gain just waiting to break out at any moment.
Well, that was 18 before Trufant got him down.
Yeah, well, Trufant has had a fantastic day, but you have your hands full every time you line up against number 23. You know, it's what, a 4-yard catch? Maybe that's two catches. I don't know, bobble. But then it turns into 18 yards because he's just so good with the ball in his hands. We said fast. Tennessee in high school, going 100, 200 meters.
First down, Irish, just short of the 40-yard line of the Huskies. Play action fake, and Clawson stepping up and decides he's going to slide down at the 35-yard line. Got 5 yards on the scramble.
Yeah, good pocket presence by Jimmy Clawson. You know, not 100% healthy, Tom. You mentioned it's not going to be entirely healthy probably till after the year. Got that turf toe on his right foot. Daniel Teonesib, number 66 for the Huskies. We haven't really called his name much. Their best defensive player that time on Sam Young's doing a terrific job on him.
Jimmy Clawson already over 300 yards passing. And Tate over 200 yards receiving. He's still in the third quarter. Armando Allen shook one man in the backfield. I don't know how he got it out to the first down marker.
Yeah, that's a good run. Now, it's not, you know, home run, but it's 5 yards when it should have been about a 1-yard gain. Well, it comes off limping.
And I remember he had a bad ankle that kept him out of the Purdue game.
That's when Robert Hughes kind of stepped in and took over.
Greg Walker, who has replaced Justin Glenn at free safety for the Huskies, made that tackle of Allen, but not until he grounded out very close to the first down, so close that they brought the sticks out for the measurement. And just that much short.
It's a smidgen, right?
A smidgen.
Let's look at the powerful run by Armando Allen. Really should have been no gain, maybe a yard loss. Shooting tackle right there. Two guys missing. Spins, turns, churns, and nearly gets the first down.
But also is shaken up and goes to the sideline. Robert Hughes has replaced him. Boston is under center. And sneaks it. And flags are down. I think the whistle sounded too before the snap was made.
False start, number 86 on the offense. 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
So Bobby Berger, guilty of the false start, which negates a first down.
Number 86 here at the bottom of the screen. Yep. I know why he's not really going to be in that play. He's had some good blocks nonetheless today.
So now it's third down and 5.
Okay.
Actually, 3rd and 6.
Where's Waldo? Right down here. Golden Tate. Over 200 yards of receptions.
No penalties against the Irish after that last step off. 3rd down and 6. Clawson falls at the 40-yard line. Protection breaking down. He had to scramble free and is down at the 40.
And some of that may be the turf, and some of it may be his turf toe, Tom. When he's got that metal plate in that right shoe, as Nick Holt kind of signals in his defense. And you know, just having trouble getting started,
yep.
You know, planning off of both throwing and running.
Well, you saw his left foot, though, slip and dig up a divot, so that wet field had something to do with it, too.
Mm-hmm.
Fogerson is ready to accept the punt from Turk. And Turk hits the end zone on the fly. So Washington holds, and they'll take over at their own 20-yard line. And we come back to Notre Dame Stadium. Has begun again at Notre Dame Stadium as Washington takes over at the 20-yard line of the Huskies. Jake Locker Chase sets up the pass and completes it to Middleton, and the tight end has a Washington first down, a 12-yard gain on first down. Kyle McCarthy finally chased the big fella down.
Yeah, just think about all the things that Steve Sarkisian is forcing John to do to kind of cover. You know, those wide receivers, bubble screens, deep throws, tight ends, some power running. Kind of mixed it up pretty doggone well.
So the Huskies came in nearly two touchdown underdogs. They have been battling toe-to-toe with the Irish. Six lead changes in the game. Locker made the fake, kept it. Not sure if he wanted to or not, because he kind of hesitated. But
still,
he
picked up 4 yards.
Yeah, he got it across the 35, where Kerry Neal hit him.
Well, we said at the top, the offense is only as good as he plays, because he is basically the offense, and he's played very, very well.
He's hit his last five passes in a row.
Thrown a touchdown, run for a touchdown. He just kind of managed the game well.
Second down. Holt bursting through a big hole and turning his way, still on his feet. Chris Polk with a stiff arm and finally chased down at the 24-yard line. That's a 40-yard run by Chris Polk.
And how about, Tommy, it looked like he was going to be tackled after about four. It was the extra yards, you know, those yards after contact that was really amazing on this run by Polk. You know, got some good blocking early on, but then broke through the tackle of Brian Smith. There's Ethan Johnson trying to get him. KO. And then old Kyle McCarthy ultimately gets him down. Boy, started the year with 90 yards rushing against LSU. He's had a nice game here against Notre Dame.
That one accounted for 40 yards and a first down at the Irish 24. Locker pumps once and then goes underneath to Curse. And Jermaine Curse blasted out of bounds by Kerry Neal.
Hey, Curse has had a real nice, dependable day, right? Said a couple times, Steve Sarkisian said, hey, why was he on the sideline so much in our loss against Stanford? Got to get him on the field. Mentioned he stood very first start last year against the Irish. Just one of those dependable guys.
Here you see his numbers, 6 receptions, 73 yards, including the score. Second down from the Irish 20. Empty backfield. Locker. And the flag down. The play is stopped.
And Fulgerson ran across the line of scrimmage before the ball was snapped.
Dead ball. Full start on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
Fulgerson, apparently not a geography major, Tom, because the ball was not snapped and he ran right. Watch him, no, 23.
That'll make it second and 11. Boop, boop, boop. At the 25.
That makes it now second down and 11. Locker still has it as he rolls to his right and flips it incomplete, intended for Fulgerson. That's going to bring up a third and long for Jake Locker from a little town, Ferndale, Washington. Population of about 9,000, but lots of friends and family making the trip from the Northwest to watch this one. Washington began by converting their first three third downs, but they're 0 for 4 since then. This one is third and 11. And another flag. The Is Notre Dame offside, or was it a false start?
False start.
False start, Washington there.
You know, not only make it a long play, they take themselves out of field goal range, right? At one point, they were on the infield goal range. Now they're a little bit out of the reach of Eric Folk.
So spot the ball back at the 30, and it's third down and 16. You see the good start they had on third, and since then they've struggled, and now they've dug themselves a big hole here. Locker pumps, delivers, and it's caught by James Johnson.
Wow.
The freshman, James Johnson, with a clutch grab for 22 yards.
I'll tell you, again, good protection, and then one of those underthrows because he was covered deep. So Jake Locker throws this a little short. James Johnson comes back and makes the good adjustment. Here's a guy who's a true freshman who started their opening game against LSU. His first catch was a touchdown against LSU and a critical catch here in the third quarter for the Huskies.
So they convert a third and 11, and now they have it first and goal. Irish 8-yard line. Chris Polk hit the backfield but not wrapped up. Still not wrapped up as he makes it back to the 5-yard line. Poor Irish tackling.
Absolutely bad tackling. Ran right through Brian Smith, but a clean shot on. You know, they had a poor tackling day last week against Purdue. Some of that's poor tackling, but some of that is Chris Polk, too. Boy, they've been talking about this, some determined runs by Chris Polk.
The Irish missing tackles, overrunning the play, everything you can think of. And so it's just inside the 5-yard line now on second and goal, inside 2 minutes of the third quarter. Quarterback draw. Jake Locker stopped short. Got it to about the 1-yard line. Scored on one of those in the first half. First touchdown by the Huskies, as a matter of fact. So now it's going to be third down.
I tell you what, if I'm Steve Sarkisian, I give my quarterback, Jake Locker, two shots at it, right? Again, it's a 5-point game.
So third and goal from the 1-yard line. Locker keeps. Still no signal. He did not get in. Stopped short of the goal line. Fourth down.
Yeah, the officials may look at that one again. And any part of the ball that crosses the line, it's a touch.
Did not break the play to the goal line, so it's fourth down.
Notre Dame's going to call a timeout.
The Irish call a timeout. Washington's going to go for it.
They're first at the half.
I mean, it's just so hard to stop a guy like that, 230 pounds, and you know, when you have, what, an inch.
So timeout Irish with 41 seconds left in the third quarter, and fourth and goal from inside the 1-yard line.
Okay, Chris Polk has really been the leader on this drive. We've talked a lot about Locker, but watch the determined runs, powerful runs by Chris Polk. Should have been stopped there. You know, some poor tackling there by the Irish, right? We talked about it a little bit later, but picks up about 32 yards on that run. Here he comes again. Should have been stuffed for a 3-yard loss. Ends up picking four. So that's his determined as you can get.
Polk, who scored 68 touchdowns in high school, was injured after two games last year, got a medical redshirt, and comes in as the Huskies' leading ground gainer, had gained 316 yards, averaging nearly 4 yards a carry, coming into today's game.
Yeah, this is a really big play. I mean, the Irish at 3-1. You know, they've dodged a few bullets. Still plenty of time here, I understand that. But they've dodged some bullets this year. But this is a very big play for the Irish defense. 5-point game right now.
Charlie Weiss and his high-powered offense have had to settle for field goals on four occasions today, as Coach Sark gets the play into his Huskies. Here we go. Inside the 1 yard line. It's fourth down and goal.
Can you run anything but the quarterback sneak blocker? Nothing.
Not with a guy like Jake Locker. Here it is. Locker keeps. And he did not make it. He did not make it. A goal line stand by the Irish.
Inside play. I think it was Ethan Johnson who got most of it. Number 9, who got some early penetration. Yeah, he had nowhere to go early. And Kerry Neal pulls him along with some help from Tail. A tremendous goal line stand by the Irish. Early penetration. He just got stuffed, had no chance to get any momentum going. And I think it was Ethan Johnson that caused most of that.
Now the Irish have to try to pound it out as they take over inside their one. Robert Hughes is in at running back. And he gets the call. And he finds a seam. And he spins his way out to a first down.
Boy, that's good defense setting up your offense, man. Pretty entertaining game. What do we say? Six lead changes. Yeah, right. And seeing the goal line stands, long plays, powerful runs by running backs, quarterbacks throwing it all over the yard.
Robert Hughes had a key run there to get them out of the shadow of their own goal line. First down, Irish, now at the 13. Hughes again. Nearly broke free again. Managed to turn out a couple of yards. Three maybe. As the third quarter comes to a close. So that's the end of the third quarter with Washington leading Notre Dame 24-19. We'll be back to Notre Dame Stadium after these messages from your local NBC station. You're watching Notre Dame football on NBC. Back at Notre Dame, Armando Allen on the sideline. Was a little gimpy when he came off the field earlier, but Alex has talked with the staff and tell us that he will be back. Right now, Robert Hughes is in at tailback. Boston's pass is caught. Hughes across the 40-yard line. 25-yard gain. So two big runs by Robert Hughes. And now 25-yard reception until Mason Foster can chase him down.
You know, he was kind of quiet the first few games of the year, but last week against Purdue, he really emerged and do it again. Number 33 right in the backfield. A little easy check down. And again, you know, everybody's looking at Kyle Rudolph. And if Kyle Rudolph is covered by three guys, it allows that check down to the tailback Robert Hughes to pick up 31.
So while they tend to, well, he's up and going. Mason Foster was the injured Husky, and he has just trotted off the field. There's a look at Robert Hughes. Five carries for 31 yards, including that 12-yard run from the 1 yard line, which was big, and then the 25-yard reception on the last play. So that was his longest career reception, 25 yards, and a big one for the Irish.
3 weeks ago, he was the third team tailback. Actually, a fullback. Yeah. He was a fullback. And James Aldrich got hurt. But now he made the most of his carries last week against Purdue and earned some more. There he was last week, averaging 4.5 yards a carry, scored a touchdown, and they were critical yards late in the game for the Irish.
So far, this drive has belonged to Robert Hughes. Michael Floyd on the sideline.
The Irish have had a penchant this year coming back in the fourth quarter time. If they do it today, it will be their fourth game this season.
They trail by 5. First down at the 41. Parsons chased, got away from one man, pumps once and delivers it on the money. It's caught by Shaquille Evans.
I'll tell you, what Jimmy Clausen's done a great job of today is, you know, avoiding people, hanging in the pocket. A couple years ago, he kind of scrambled and get sacked, but he's just keeping his eyes downfield, moving around the pocket. Watched a lot of tape of Tom Brady in the offseason. Watched how he moved around the pocket. He's doing that so much better than a year ago. Eyes downfield, find Shaquille Evans.
For 15 yards and a first down. 44 of the Huskies. Washington shows blitz. Hand off to Hughes. Robert Hughes, one-on-one in the secondary. Down the sideline, and Hughes inside the 10-yard line, knocked out of bounds. Big run by Robert Hughes, who has been the featured back on this series. That one goes for 37 yards.
And, Tom, when you have that kind of hole, Trevor Robinson, Sam Young, Eric Olson have to do a good job. Watch Olson, watch Young, and again, even Chris Stewart getting a piece of his guy. There wasn't really a white jersey around. Chris Stewart did a great job of pulling and knocking his guy.
Pulled and got the first man in the hole, and that sprung Robert Hughes. Boy, Hughes, what a drive he's having. The Irish now, this is where they've stalled today, though. Four times they've had to settle for field goals. First and goal at the 7. Play action fake. Clausen all day. Looks in the end zone. Off the pads of Robbie Parris.
Once again, Desmond Trufant kind of gets a hand in the way of Robbie Parris, Tom. Again, but he was open. This is one I thought maybe he'd drill. Kind of lobbed it to Parris, who was open. Look at the protection that he has. Good in and out smash move. Again, Trufant does a great job of kind of getting in the way of the pass to Robbie Parris.
Second down and goal at the 7. Robert Hughes. Can't get free this time, only to the 5-yard line where he's stopped by Teo Nessa.
Here, one thing, Nick Holt told us this week that they had a tackle. The Huskies had a tackle a lot better. They have. And after giving up 321 yards last week in rushing, just 106 so far today. Tate down here, a guy that's been awesome today.
And watch for Rudolph here in the end zone. He's in the slot at the top. That one's up for grabs.
Trufant again knocks it away from Golden Tate. Yeah, what kind of game has Desmond Trufant had?
Man, you see why the coaches.
Yeah, they said he's going to be a fantastic player. He's been fantastic today. Golden Tate down at the bottom, and Jimmy Clausen was kind of looking. This is the matchup that they said, Charlie Weiss said, we want. We want Golden Tate against a freshman Trufant, and Trufant has won his fair share of battles. And Tom, you're right. Once again, Notre Dame didn't get punched into the end zone and faced with a field goal attempt.
Taus for the fifth time today. This one, 24 yards. Taus with his fifth field goal, but a bittersweet one for the Irish as they drive down the field and settle for 3 and still trail Washington. Nick Taus, who has tied a Notre Dame record with 5 field goals in the game. The last time it was done, Nick Setta against Washington State in 2003. Caught from behind and down to the 25-yard line as we go to Jimmy Roberts in our New York studio for a U.S. Bank Serving You snapshot.
All right, Tom, Alabama and Kentucky. The Tide has won 33 of the last 35 in this series. We pick it up late second quarter. Alabama up 8. Kentucky's Derek Locke, the catch, the hit, and he gives it right back. Call it the turning point of the game, but it was one of many. The Tide rolls. The Cats with 4 turnovers. Alabama is 5-0. They have now scored 30 points in 5 straight games for the first time in 30 years. Tom, back to you.
Jimmy, the Crimson Tide in Florida, that's shaping up as some showdown, isn't it? Although the Gators go to LSU next weekend. Jake Locker throws it low, incomplete, intended for Goodwin. That Notre Dame just can't seem to put it away when they get the ball down in the red zone.
But remember, you know, they gave games away last year like this. They never really, you know, they had games like Syracuse and North Carolina where they just couldn't put teams away when they had leads and such. But, you know, this year they've come from behind, as we said, against Michigan, Michigan State, Purdue. They lost the Michigan game, but they still came from 11 points down in the fourth quarter.
Saw Jimmy Clausen and Dane Crist comparing notes over there on the sideline, hoping to get back on the field. Clausen, if the defense can hold, and they are off to a good start. Chris Polk is stopped in his tracks by Steve Feiler.
This is as good as the interior line for Notre Dame has played all season long. They've missed some tackles, but boy, they've made some good plays. Both of those downs. From the 4-6, Steve Feiler, the defensive coach, just said they were going to play him more today than they have. Good penetration by Feiler. Sophomore out of Chicago.
So here's a third down, third and long for the Huskies. Jake Locker rolling to his left, throwing back across his body and has a first down as Jermaine Kearse catches it and gets the final couple of yards for the first down. A gain of 12. Kyle McCarthy made the stop for Notre Dame. Big third down conversion, another one by Washington.
A 7th catch by Kearse, Tom. A guy that is really, really kind of set the tone for this passing game. He was telling us this week, Kearse, was that one of the big reasons he came to Washington because of Jake Locker. Said, hey, I knew I had a quarterback that could get me the ball in situations just like that.
Polk breaking free for a moment and scooting out of another tackle before they surround him and get him down. He is really showing us the ability to break tackles today.
And he's been showing the Husky coaches all season long. As I said, you know, he got hurt last year, didn't have any tape of him to watch.
This one goes for 19 yards.
Once again, he comes limping off the field, though. But
and Gary Gray.
Good pull and block by Kelemente in the 56. Well, good pull at least.
Kind of whipped on the block.
He did, but it was a nice looking pull, wasn't it?
Fogerson replaces Polk. Homer's in there at fullback. Play action fake. Jake Locker's going for the end zone for Kearse.
Oh, boy.
Couldn't make the one-handed catch.
It's like a Golden Tate kind of play. Throw it up to Golden, let him go get it. Jermaine Kearse, 7 catches in the day. We just said that Gary Gray has pretty good coverage on him. Perfect position did Gray have, number 4 for the Irish. Look it back into the backfield. Yeah, that's just a good defensive play, and nonetheless, Jermaine Kearse almost makes the play. Wow.
Second down and 10. Running play to Fogerson. And it'll bring up another third down.
Well, in these third and threes, ordinarily most teams just say, hey, you know, let's drop back in coverage. And they're going to throw the tight end, maybe it back. But again, as we've seen with Jake Locker, he's just that extra dimension.
You're going to need to come up with a third down stop on one of these series. We got an empty backfield here with Jake Locker.
Well, that usually means draw.
He He's looking to throw it, and he does. Incomplete. Intended for Goodwin.
Steve Sarkisian has a decision to make, right? Do you punt it, play defense, or you're not in field goal range.
Ball at the 36-yard line. Fourth down. Looks like they're going to go for it.
Well, I think he's got some confidence in the way his defense is playing.
Now a little indecision.
And they're going to end up using their second timeout, which is valuable in a close ball game to burn that second timeout.
So timeout Washington to discuss a fourth down. We'll have it when we come back to Notre Dame Stadium. Huskies by two. Steve Sarkisian, the Washington coach, electing to go for it on fourth down. It's fourth down and three. Charlie Weiss can only watch from the sideline, hoping his defense can make a play. Washington leads Notre Dame by two. On fourth and three, blitz comes. Locker fires. It is caught for a Washington first down at the 30-yard line by Kavario Middleton.
Well, that's a clutch play. I mean, good coverage by Sergio Brown, but the tight end made a nice adjustment. You know, you see wide receivers do that a lot, but this time Middleton, the tight end, made a great adjustment. It's number 80 in the middle of the screen. Goes down low. It looked like, you know, Sergio Brown had a chance to pick it off. A great throw and then a real good adjustment by Middleton. Very, very pleased Steve Sarkisian.
And Middleton used that 253 pounds to keep Brown off the football. So another third down conversion. Blitz shown by the Irish. On first down, a pitch to Polk. He's got a blocker in front. Chris Polk cutting up and still keeping on his feet inside the 15-yard line. 16 yards as he chugged his way to another first down.
You're old enough to remember Jim Brown.
Yeah.
He's breaking tackles like Jim Brown. My goodness, Chris Paul just can't get your arms around. I guess you get your arms around him, but just can't bring him down. Good block by Middleton. See number 80, big block by Middleton. How about Ben Osai? 335 pounds a man, kind of pushing people down. And Manti Te'o just holding on for dear life.
Irish trying to stop as Polk has his first career 100-yard game. If Washington can score, it'll be a two-possession game. Chris Polk dancing his way this time, and still, once he's surrounded, moving the pile ahead. And the clock is down inside 8.5 minutes. The Irish involved in three straight games and decided in the final minute, inside the final minute, losing to Michigan and then beating Michigan State and beating Purdue. The defense won the game against Michigan State, the offense against Purdue.
All I can say is for those coaches in the Pac-10 in the years ahead, watch out for Washington.
Second down and four from the Irish 8. Chris Polk gets it to the 6-yard line. Stopped by Brian Smith.
Third and about one, huh, Tom?
On the third down. Yeah. Sarkisian rolling the dice on fourth down. The Huskies have never beaten Notre Dame. They're 0-7 against the Fighting Irish.
Good play callers keep the defense on their heels. Steve Sarkisian has done that today.
6-yard line. It's third down and two. Chris Polk has the first down and the touchdown. Six-yard touchdown run by Chris Polk, and the Irish just unable to stop Washington on critical downs.
I'll tell you, this is a quick, unbelievable running day by Chris Polk. And just to remind you again, 0-12 a year ago, didn't come close to people's program. Was in a
rolling on the field. Is that a review?
That's going to get reviewed.
Going to review it. I'd say that Chris was a pretty good mutter, wouldn't you?
Yeah, absolutely. Let's have a look at Chris Polk hit by, where's the ball? His knee's down, but I think that ball's over. It's not where his knee is, it's where the ball is. I believe that's a touchdown.
Where the ball is when the knee goes down. And
where's the ball?
Can't really tell from that angle, can you?
Yeah. I think that's a touchdown, Tom.
This will probably be your best look right here.
Yeah. Get any part of that goal line, it's a touch. And I don't think they can reverse that.
Nope. I think the touchdown will stand.
And as you're right, you know, two score game, and Charlie's got some work to do. Now, yeah, he came down from 11 points down to Michigan a few weeks ago. But
yeah, if they kick the extra point here, it's a two possession game. So it's an all important extra point, too.
Well, indeed. And they blocked that extra point against Michigan State, which ultimately probably won the game for the Irish. So that was Ethan Johnson doing that a few weeks ago.
Chris Polk with some determined running at Notre Dame Stadium today, hoping they can give the Huskies their first ever win against the Irish.
So Keijan just has a confidence about him that's infectious.
Determined that the runner's knee was down. The ball will be placed at the half-yard line.
Now, I don't agree with the call. It's not the knee again. It's where the ball is when the knee goes down. But they're going to call him short.
Here it is again.
Is that conclusive, Tom? Okay, first down. They've had some trouble last time they got down to the 1 yard line.
Notre Dame had a goal line stand earlier from about this point. Toss it to Polk. Can't turn the corner.
They lost yardage. Again, I'm running Jake Locker four times if I'm down there now. But they stuffed him inside in the quarterback sneak before, so Sarkisian calls a pitch. And he lost a yard.
Meanwhile, the clock ticking away. And if they score and hit the extra point, it'll be a two-possession game. So second and goal. Locker rolls, his pass incomplete. Intended for Goodwin. Now third down.
Would you have run Locker on a few quarterback sneaks? I mean, they were on the 1 yard line, give him four chances to run it in. Had him just a little bit wide.
Well, third down, though, the Irish have been unable to stop them on this drive. And for much of the game. Fake it to Polk. Locker still has it. Now he's going to run. And he will be hit and stopped. It'll be fourth down. Torian Smith got there first. And the field goal unit is coming out.
I promise you, Steve Sarkisian tomorrow will say, should have snuck in three times. Good defensive stand by the Irish once again.
The second goal line stand inside the 1 yard line by the Notre Dame defense. A 20-yard field goal attempt by Eric Folk. It is up, and it is a flag down. Good.
Personal
foul. Oh. Roughing the snapper. Number 95.
First down.
Half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
Ian Williams roughing the snapper.
Wow. Personal foul gives him an automatic first down. Now we have seen everything. Nose tackle Ian Williams. Center of the screen, number 95. in the blue jersey. I couldn't see anything
what,
there, Tom.
What was it?
Oh, yeah.
In any event, first and goal again. And Chris Polk, again, he has stopped short of the goal line.
That's it. That interior of the defensive line for the Irish have been just awesome down here.
Roughing the snap, right?
I didn't see him. You know, the only way is that he gets his hands in his face. 95 on the left. I can't see anything there. You know, maybe an elbow to the face. I couldn't see anything.
I've never seen that. Second and goal. Inside 5 minutes. Pitch to Polk. And again, they stopped him.
Brian Smith again. This ain't fumble.
I would say they fumbled the ball. And the officials, as you can tell, have made no signal yet. Now discussion underway.
We're going to stop in that play. The cap by Lewis Moore.
Prior to the play, false start on the offense.
Boy.
5 yard penalty, second down.
So if it was indeed a recovered fumble, the false start negates it.
Please reset the game clock to 4 minutes, 51 seconds.
One thing is Washington's going to have to throw it in. They're not going to be able to run it in, right? They've been stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Now with the penalty, they're going to have to get Jake Locker is going to have to make a play.
Repeat second down. The ball now back at the 6 yard line. Locker fakes, passes it complete, stops short of the goal line to the fullback, Paul Homer.
How about Kyle McCarthy? That looked like from up here, an easy score.
Yeah.
Kyle McCarthy comes out of nowhere to make the play. McCarthy, their leading tackler in every game, intercepted 3 passes. Unbelievable. Kyle McCarthy, that looked like a touchdown easily. Kyle McCarthy on the right side of the screen, 28. Makes a play.
Third down and goal from the one. Sneak by Locker.
No.
Did not make it. It's going to be fourth down.
You know, we've been around a lot of games. I've never seen as good a goal line defense in any college team as I've seen from Notre Dame today.
Can they do it a third time?
Well, it's fourth down. They got to kick it, don't they?
Sent the field goal unit out last time, and here he does.
Boy, great defense by the Irish.
That's 3 times they have had the ball inside their 1 yard line, and 3 times they have stopped Washington from scoring a touchdown.
Well, this makes it a 5-point game if he can make it, so critical kick.
Eric Folk, and a flag down. Another flag.
Play of game.
This is a delay of game.
5 yard penalty. Remains fourth down.
Make it a 23-yard field goal attempt. Maybe the angle not quite so acute either.
This game really has had everything.
Remember the last time that the Irish thought they had stopped personal foul roughing the snapper. Gave Washington another chance and still couldn't punch it in. Now the full field goal attempt. 23 yards. And Eric Folk boots it through.
All right, Jimmy Clausen's going to have to do it again.
2 minutes, 52 seconds left. Goal line stand gives them a chance. Clausen on the field when we come back. '27-22 Washington. Jimmy Clausen trying to rally his troops on the sideline. But first, the kickoff. Here's Riddick. Dodges a couple. Gets to the outside. Cuts back. And he's across the 35-yard line. And that's where Jimmy Clausen will take over when we return for a rousing finale at Notre Dame Stadium. High drama under the lights on a rainy day at Notre Dame Stadium. Washington and the Irish have gone back and forth all afternoon. Three goal line stands by Notre Dame give them a chance with 2:56 on the clock. Jimmy Clausen at quarterback on first down. There's a flag down as Clausen scrambles and throws it away.
Brilliant defense by the Irish late in this fourth quarter, but both these quarterbacks have done a magnificent job of kind of keeping their teams alive.
Offside, number one on the defense. 5-yard penalty, replay first down.
Crichton offside gives the Irish 5 yards. That's the defensive coordinator, Nick Holt, of the Huskies.
Tom, we talked about how resilient this Irish team has been this year coming from behind. And, it, you know, just the calmness about Jimmy Clausen in these situations and the belief that his teammates have in him.
From the Notre Dame 42. Clausen's pass is caught. Diving catch made by the freshman, Shaquille Evans.
We have plenty of time and also two timeouts remaining. Time will not be the issue. It's how good Washington's defense is will be the issue.
Set the ball right on the midfield stripe. First down for the Irish. Washington leads by 5. Low snap, Clausen has it. Now has to scramble and throws on the run, and it's caught by Robbie Parris. He's inside the Washington 30 with an Irish first down. Gain of 20 yards.
Well, Robbie Parris, who's in the slot, again, made a couple of valuable catches, important, significant catches last week and then today. Remember the 3rd and 14 last week against Purdue, he caught for 15. Another significant catch for Parris.
First down Irish at the Husky 30. Play action fake. Clausen looks one way, turns the other. Now still looking and forced to scramble and tripped up as he gets back to the line of scrimmage and inside the 30-yard line where Deshaun Matthews tackles him.
I'll tell you, this offensive line has given Jimmy Clausen a lot of protection in time. It tells you the coverage has been pretty good by the Huskies.
Gained about a yard on his scramble. Buck down to 140.
And it's about time to see a little something from Golden Tate, isn't it?
Tate time. Clausen drills it to Golden Tate. Tate's inside the 20. It got away from one man. Is out of bounds. Stops the clock at the 12-yard line. A gain of 17 yards to Golden Tate. Nate Williams knocked him out.
You know, the play just begins when he catches it. The hard part is bringing him down. Down here at the bottom of the screen, not a significant route, but there's just no linebackers in the way. But this guy now has about 260 yards of offense today, does Golden Tate. Top of the show, they said they're going to put him in 5 or 6 different positions, and that's what we've seen. He's played X, Z, running back, return punts.
Clausen came over to the sideline between plays to get the call from Coach Weiss. Down to 6 as he goes for the end zone. Rudolph. Touchdown!
Go for 2-point play here, Tom, and Joey Weiss said he was going to do that. Split his tight end, Kyle Rudolph, let the old basketball player just go up and get it.
That's what he did to win the game against Purdue. That's what he does here. Kyle Rudolph in the corner of the end zone from Jimmy Clausen.
Yeah, the way this game has gone, though, Jake Locker is going to have his own chance, right, with 120 and still a timeout remaining.
The Irish went 57, or got 57 yards off the arm of Clawson as he hit 4 for 4 on the drive, and now they go for two. They have been successful on 1 out of 2 2-point conversions this season. That's the fake where they were successful before as they snap it to Robert Hughes, and Hughes, like a road grader, into the end zone. Flags are down.
Unreal. Defensive line played great, and then Robert Hughes played like a defensive lineman as he burst through that. The defense had just kind of kept chugging.
Now, there is no foul on the play. The action was legal.
So no foul. They pick up the flag.
Well, let's go back to the touchdown first. 6'6", Kyle Rudolph split out as a wide receiver. Detached. He's ordinarily a tight end, but they detach him and throw the ball over a 6-foot defensive back, Quentin Richardson, a guy that Nick Holt was kind of riding earlier.
Clawson put it where only his man could get it. And Kyle Rudolph got it.
And then a 2-point play. I mean, holy smokes. You talk about it. We talk about a lot of determined runs, right? Look how he was stopped right there at about the 4-yard line. And they get their own push here. Did you see that?
The direct snap to Hughes as Clawson faked as if the ball had gone over his head. And Hughes just moved, I think, 22 people. I don't know.
Yeah, it was. But you remember, you remember the Reggie Bush push a few years ago. Yeah. It looked like the offensive lineman for Notre Dame.
Had lots of them.
But watch here as he stopped there. You see Eric Olson did number 55, just kind of pushing his way in. And Robert Hughes gets to the end zone. Critical 2-point play.
So now it's 30-27 with a minute 20 left. And you know how good Jake Locker and Chris Polk have been today.
Yeah, and he's got one timeout remaining. Needs to get the ball to around the 30-yard line to give his kicker a legitimate shot.
Will it be another game-winning drive? Clawson to Rudolph for the clincher. This is the stuff of Notre Dame legend. If they can hold on, Nick Tausch is ready to kick it off. Good kick, and it gets by Richardson. Picks it up. Taken out at about the 10-yard line. Steve Filer on special teams, and a big hole for Jake Locker.
And the loudest part of the stadium right in front of the student section of the Irish. One timeout remaining for Locker. Now, these are these magical moments, though, that if you're a kid growing up as a quarterback, Seattle, South Bend, wherever, you dream of these moments.
And the two friends, Jake Locker and Jimmy Clawson, have been something else today. Locker has a minute 16. Locker's pass is complete to Middleton. The tight end close to the 20-yard line, able to get out of bounds to stop the clock. It stops at a minute 9. As you said, Pat, Huskies have one timeout.
Absolutely, and you know, the guy who's been so clutch for the Huskies in the passing game is Jermaine Kearse, number 15. Guy that has caught 7 passes and a touchdown. Number 15 up there at the top of the screen.
Locker has the completion and able to hold on is Kearse, despite the fact he took a pretty good hit.
He's got some strong hands just like Golden Tate.
Clock stops, or should have stopped on
Now it's going.
And is rewound, stopped on the first down, and then is rewound. Locker's pass is broken up. Good defense and a flag down. Sergio Brown on Jermaine Kearse. Is it going to be interference?
Pass interference. Number 41 on the defense. Automatic first down for spot.
Number 31. Tom.
Here it is.
Looked like a pretty good defensive play.
I thought he might have had his right hand around his waist. Anyway, back to action. Locker's going deep. And the pass just overshoots his intended receiver, Curse. Darren Walls running with him.
Yeah, Curse had a step or two on Darren Walls. Maybe a little bit more air under it. Curse runs under it. Little slant and go. That's, you know, good call. They run two straight slants, then a slant and go. A good reaction, recovery by Darren Walls.
Locker huddling up. 47 ticks. Mawson can only watch while his defense tries to save the game. They had three brilliant goal line stands to give them a chance. And Carson took him down the field for the lead. Now the defense called on again. Chasing Jake Locker. Pulls up, throws it away. Smart play by Jake Locker. But it'll bring up third down with 40 seconds left.
You know, John Tenuta just hasn't brought much pressure until that play. Two or three linebackers coming in on Jake Locker, flushed him out of the pocket, had absolutely nowhere to go. So a nice change of pace by Tenuta.
Somewhere behind the raindrops rain, upstairs. Locker in the pocket, whips it downfield, and he's got a man, and it's caught at the 25-yard line. Caught by James Johnson, 38 yards on a Washington first down.
How about James Johnson, the absolute true freshman? You know, the critical part of the game is to go into the true freshman, James Johnson. To mention his very first catch, a touchdown in college football. Makes an incredible play there.
25-yard line. Locker looks one way, goes the other, now rolls to his left, and will step out of bounds, stopping the clock with 22 seconds left.
Well, Steve Sarkisian has some ways to play this, right? You gotta take a couple shots. He's in field goal range now, but Jake Locker just has to make sure he didn't get sacked or turn it over. James Johnson, what an adjustment by this guy. Just, you know, the big stage of college football hasn't, this is the last play to Johnson, hasn't really fazed him much. Pretty good coverage by Blanton, just out jumps him. Throws a Kyle Rudolph on him.
22 seconds left from the Notre Dame 23-yard line. Flag is down.
False start.
False start by the Huskies.
5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
Every 5 yards makes it harder on your kicker.
Yeah, right now it'd be about a 45-yard field goal.
Yeah, his long is 46.
And in the rain.
Yeah, it's not perfect conditions. Yeah, saving that one timeout is really important for the Huskies now.
Hope hit the game winner against USC. Locker pumps, delivers, tipped, and was it intercepted? It's Mr. Dependable, Kyle McCarthy. Man, the ball, I think, was tipped. It came out of Locker's hand, fell way short, and McCarthy with a diving interception.
Okay, Steve Sarkisian saying, stay out there. I want to see a review. But Kyle McCarthy, 4 interceptions on the year if it holds up. Saved the game against Michigan State with an interception. The ball was tipped. They're going to review it upstairs. Well, that hits the ground.
Hit the ground. That's no good.
Yeah, that's...
that's no interception.
That will be overturned for sure. Of course, I said that when I thought they scored the touchdown a while back, too.
Looks like it hits the ground right there. Definitely.
It did hit the ground.
So Kyle McCarthy apparently had the interception, but we think it's going to be overruled.
You know, some guys just seem to be in the right place at the right time, and Kyle McCarthy is one of those dudes.
Does have 12 tackles today, does McCarthy. So Robert Welsh and Ed Ferrante of the Big East looking at the replay.
And Steve Sarkisian's thinking, hey, you know, I've got 17 seconds. If you get, you know, a pass in the middle of the field, guys, you better get down. If you get the first down, obviously the clock stops. But there's a lot of time permutations going through the headset of Steve Sarkisian, which he's talking to his quarterback, Jake Locker, about.
After further review, it was determined that the pass hit the ground and is incomplete. It is third down and 12 from the 28-yard line.
So the Irish defense returns to the field, and the Washington offense has had a chance to huddle with their coach with 17 seconds and a timeout left.
You know, I think he's got a timeout. I think he's got to try to just get 5, 6, 7 yards. That 5-yard penalty really hurt the Huskies.
They're back to the 28. That was the line of scrimmage when the last play was run. They're back to the 28-yard line, and it's now third down. Quarterback draw. Jake Locker still going, and out of bounds. Ducks out of bounds, giving his man Folk a chance to kick the field goal to tie the game with 11 seconds left. So there's Eric Folk. Missed only one field goal all season long. Hit the game winner against USC. This one to tie it with 11 seconds left. It'll be a 37-yard attempt. See if Notre Dame tries to ice him here with a timeout. Yards to tie it, and here comes the timeout. So Eric Folk, the sophomore from Woodland Hills, California, gets a laugh and a grin. It's been a classic in the rain in South Bend.
Interesting. Most coaches stay away from kickers, won't really talk to him. He was just saying, right, hey, enjoy the moment. This is what you practiced your entire life for.
Speaking of the moment, how important was that Robert Hughes two-point conversion carried half the team into
Indeed.
The end zone?
You know, there were like 20 different plays that could have changed the game. This is the two-point play by Hughes. A little push by the offensive lineman carries Robert Hughes in, and that put him up by three.
To tie the game. It's down on its way, and it is good.
What a drive by Jake Locker, too, huh? But we've seen two really good quarterbacks, phenomenal defense on both teams, great goal line defense. And a very, very pleased Steve Sarkisian. That's as pleased as he gets. Well, you know, his calmness, I think, is an asset, an attribute in the fire of a game.
Still thinking of what plays he's going to call now in overtime.
Yeah.
The field goal drive, they went 70 yards in 9 plays and a minute 14 seconds with Folk's 37-yard field goal, tying it at 30 with 6 seconds now on the clock. I guess every game Notre Dame plays is going to be close now. Huh?
Well, it's good for us, bad for traffic.
4 straight now for the Irish, and Jake Locker has had a game. You know, he made the friends of a young man, Kyle Roget, that had a brain tumor, inoperable, finally passed away. And Jake was telling us the other day that the young man has been an inspiration to him in his life and his football play. Standing young man, and he and Jimmy Clausen have been as advertised during this game today. Riddick on the hop. Theo Riddick. As time runs out, and we're headed to overtime.
I'll tell you, as good as these kickers are, it's probably going to take a touchdown to win this thing in overtime, I think. Dawson has once again just been magnificent. He has had a phenomenal year thus far. The statistics have been phenomenal, and the come from behinds have been remarkable. 400 yards passing. Joe Theismann holds the record. I think it's five something or other that he threw against USC in the 70s, but Jimmy Clausen just been phenomenal.
Should the overtime go three or more?
And he still has work to do.
Indeed.
A two-point conversion.
And so has Jake Locker had been phenomenal.
Each team is allowed one timeout in each overtime series.
It's nice to see guys enjoy the moment. You know, it's you work so hard, and you know, you go from the classroom to recess, as John Tenuta says. This counts as recess, the game itself.
And how ironic that the two friends, Jimmy Clausen and Jake Locker, who became friends attending the same camp and had their families tailgating together after the game in Seattle last year in a shootout. There's Sam Young, head above everybody else, the redhead, trying to rally his offensive line. It's been some game.
Yeah. Just saw the helmet of one of the Irish players. All the paint had been knocked off.
Enough.
Scott Smith, a great special teams player for the Irish.
Seven lead changes in this one. As we go out, there's the paint off the helmets.
Yeah.
As we go out for the coin toss. Jake Locker is going to represent the Huskies.
And they started with four captains. Now they're down to one, the Huskies. Both defensive lines are going to be tired after this game. You know, the chasing Jimmy Clausen and this guy, Jake Locker.
Like Washington wins the toss. So they will elect, no doubt, to go on defense first as Clausen
Washington
and Locker
wins
exchange.
The toss. Elects to play
slap.
Defense first.
So Washington wins that toss. They'll start on defense, and we'll be back with overtime after these messages. You're watching Notre Dame football on NBC. The toss, electing to play defense, so they know what they'll need. Each team gets a possession from the opponent's 25-yard line. They must go for two, starting with the third overtime. So the Irish at the 25-yard line. First possession in overtime. Scrambling to his right, loads and fires to Tate. Golden Tate airborne to the 3-yard line.
He is fun to watch, Golden Tate, but he's hard to cover. I'll tell you that. You're an Irish fan, you love him. If you're a Husky fan, look out.
22 yards on the play.
He wears a couple wristbands. He showed us yesterday. One says, "Don't be satisfied," and boy, he certainly hasn't.
Cartwheel to the turf.
We had a leap last week over a Purdue defender, too, and a running play.
Looks like a Husky is injured on the play. It's Nate Williams there. Fine safety. That would be a big loss here in overtime. They've already lost Justin Glenn. They're starting free safety.
Number 8 in the white jersey.
That is
man on the tackle.
Did he get Tate's
okay, got
knee
in
the
head? Yeah. Guy who had an interception against Notre Dame last season. Happy to see him walking off. Well, let's see if they can punch it in. The Irish can punch it in. The Huskies had some trouble in the fourth quarter.
Of course, scoring has been a problem for Notre Dame. They've had to settle the field goals many times today.
Fine.
Here they are, first and goal. And pounding its way in, the flag down. Pounding to the 1-yard line. for Hughes. Let's check the penalty now.
Offside by the defense. Half the distance of goal. Replay first down.
The replay first down, half the distance to Nick Holt's chagrin. But the Irish have threatened and had to settle for field goals on five occasions today. Now trying to punch it in overtime.
You got 247-pound Robert Hughes, who's been awfully good inside the tackles today.
Tight formation. Hughes straight ahead for the touchdown. Offensive line once again cratering the defense of the Huskies, as they have on running plays here late in the game a couple of times, including the two-point conversion that enabled this game to go to overtime.
But Chris Stewart and Eric Olson and Sam Young, Trevor Robinson, all those guys. Great block by Sam Young and Chris Stewart as well.
Look at Sam Young.
Yeah, just elated. The offensive linemen love those kinds of plays. Smash mouth.
Nick Tausch, extra point attempt. It is good. So the Irish get their possession to open overtime and score a touchdown. The big play, a 23-yard pass to Golden Tate. And then Robert Hughes pounds it in.
Now Golden Tate has 9 catches, Tom, 244 yards on the day. He's also had, he opened the game with a run for 31 yards.
And Jimmy Clausen has had his career day.
Well, the Irish, this is how they got the overtime, because the Irish defense had a big, big day, particularly in short yardage plays. This was third and goal for the Huskies down in Irish territory. Stopped the really elusive and strong Jake Locker. And then Kyle McCarthy makes this play, because I thought this was going to be a touchdown. Kyle McCarthy saved the day, and that was their last play. Couldn't sneak it in.
So now Washington with the ball on offense in overtime. They need a touchdown. Locker retreats, hit as he delivers, and the pass is incomplete.
Good coverage by Robert Blanton, number 12.
That position on Fogerson, and the ball incomplete. It'll be second down.
Great, great coverage by Blanton. It's one of these delicate, number two, Darren Walls. Oh, here's Blanton. Well, it was Walls that was on the outside, Robert Blanton, who made the play on the ball.
Second down. Locker being chased and sacked. Harry Neal with the sack of Jake Locker for a loss of 10.
This defensive line of the Irish, you know, they stuff him down on the goal line, and in the passing situation, then Kerry Neal makes a really important sack to make it, what, third and 21. Kerry Neal down here, just right off the edge, blew right by Ben Osai. Bad block by Osai allows the sack by Neal.
Third down, 19. Blitz comes from the Irish. Locker gets protection, pumps once, rolls out, and is passed through the hands of his intended receiver, Kearse.
Yeah, Kearse was so worried about his feet, he forgot about his hands.
It's going to be fourth down.
And Kearse, who's had an awfully strong day, 8 catches, almost 100 yards. See, I really think he was worried about his feet. This is the catch he's made all day long. That would have been a first.